They've been working it out. Right, Bobo?
Yeah, right.
You've been telling David when he has to, you know, pop in and stuff. What part are you giving him?
I'm giving him the part at the end and a little bit at the beginning here.
So not much, right?
It's your own arrangement then. You're rearranging it.
Yeah.
Because
it's nice.
Yeah, exactly.
Because Springsteen didn't really sing a duet. It was his song, man.
Yeah, exactly. So I just had to put in a little bit, all right?
Yeah.
I couldn't leave him out entirely.
Okay. All right. And did you say hi to Otto? Otto from Otto and George, everyone.
Hi, Otto.
He's right in front of you. I don't know why you're looking over there.
You're waving at no one, David.
Hi, Otto. You were great at the virus tour. I saw you at the virus show.
Keep this mental patient away from me. How did he breach the wall of security? Is he going to kill Harvey Milk or what?
Hey, Otto, are you from Jersey?
I'm from Staten Island, New York, originally.
Wow, Staten Island.
Do you live in Jersey now?
I live in Jersey now.
Bobo? Now, hold on, Bobo. Otto, from Otto and George, you know, the you got to work in George the puppet. Used to live in Staten Island, now lives in Jersey, and he's a funny guy. Go ahead.
Otto, he's a comedian, and he sticks his hand up a puppet's ass. He was from Staten Island, now he lives in Jersey!
Yes! David again just laughing his ass off. Thinks it's the funniest
thing.
Yeah,
it's great. The level of taste of the show is still about fucking exploiting the mentally ill.
We love finding the new ones, Otto.
Yeah, it's great.
And then we kick the old ones out.
Yeah.
Beat it, stupid.
You're last year's news.
Yeah, really.
Last year's burden.
We got Danny outside yet? Danny? No?
That was a very good song.
All right, no Danny yet.
No?
No.
What the hell's going on? It's downstairs. Right, what, did he stop at a bar?
All right, we're trying to figure it out with Mars. Yeah, we have every single microphone possible on right now.
Yes, I can't wait till it all just blows up.
Otto, what are you promoting?
Oh, I'm working at that Primetime in Sayreville. It's still open in spite of Colin Quinn's weekend there.
What happened at the Colin Quinn weekend?
Just fucking with him. I don't know.
Yeah,
I wasn't there. I was in Florida.
Yeah. All right.
He's insinuating that Colin probably would have, you know, the guy would have just closed the doors and locked it after Quinn.
Yeah.
Ruined
Mr.
things.
Too hip for the room. Nobody knows what he's talking about. Punchlines.
And mumble under his breath.
Yeah.
Well,
folks, leaning on a fucking mic stand, talking to flowers.
Yeah.
Is that what he's doing now?
Yeah.
Well, politics.
But we could absolutely move on to other things while we're waiting for young Daniel on the street.
I think we're going to do it by phone. Is that what?
Yes. Yeah.
All right. So I think he's calling it right now.
No way. I thought he was going to do that in the first place. There's no way the mic was going to work down
there. That's a good point. Danny from the sidewalk. Danny!
Hey, fellas. How are you?
Hi.
Why does everybody have to be gay?
What kind of crowd we got out there?
We got a very, very large crowd. There's over 50 people out here on the sidewalk. It's three-quarters of the way down the block.
Jesus.
Ooh. And they're all pissed off, and they're waiting in the rain.
Right.
Well, there were no guarantees.
No.
Attaboy, Ant.
Yes.
Yeah, Sam is now down here with me, and we're giving out some stuff to the guys online just in case they don't get a chance to make it upstairs.
That way they could throw it at us when we leave because they didn't get in.
They're all screaming for prizes, presents.
Gimme, gimme, gimme.
Yeah. Gimme, gimme, gimmies.
You know, this day isn't about you guys. It's about us having to fucking leave this great studio that they built for us. And go to pretty much what amounts to Guantanamo, where we're under the watchful eye of all the bosses.
Yeah.
We're not very well liked. We got a broadcast from a studio that's like a walk-in closet.
Well, the bosses, you know, they know what good radio is.
I don't know about that. Red paddle.
Red paddle.
What?
Red paddle's up.
Just because you wear a tie, you don't know good radio? I'm being sarcastic, obviously.
I'm going to have to red paddle myself because I really want to start talking about that. But
thank God we got a week in between this and that.
Yeah.
Danny, anything else?
Well, if you want, we could talk to some of the guys that are waiting out here in the cold rain and see how happy they are about that.
Sure, why not?
store. Hang on a second. Hey, sir, what is your name?
My name's Steve.
And, Steve, are you thinking that you're going to get upstairs today?
From the looks of the line, no.
Well, are you looking for anything in particular from the studio that you would want as, like, a parting gift?
Not in particular.
You just want to come and hang, huh?
I just want to hang out with the guys.
And how do you feel about being out in the cold rain?
Beautiful day to wait for O'Neill.
Oh, okay.
Well, he doesn't seem to mind so much.
All right.
I was told by Kenny that it was suicide to come out here because everybody was really pissed off and cold.
Hey, Danny, you know what we might have? Actually, Otto has a good idea. It's a bit self-serving, but a couple of Otto and George free giveaway tickets for Friday, April 3rd at his show.
Ooh.
Today.
Tonight. Okay, is it at the Sayreville show? Find out if there's anybody down there from Jersey who wants Otto and George tickets.
He's from New Jersey who wants to go see Otto and George tonight.
I hope Vinny Brand's out there.
I don't know what I agreed to.
What's that?
One guy said, I don't know what I agreed to.
Otto and George?
Yeah.
Oh, I got to get back to school. I won't be able to do that. Well, that guy's not going to be able to make it tonight.
School?
But I'm sure we'll be
he
able
can't
to
be one of our listeners.
Yeah. He's a pedophile.
Yeah. I'll get their information and bring it up.
Okay, I got four tickets to hand them.
Very
four
good.
Four tickets, no problem. We'll do.
All right. Thank you, Danny.
Okay. You guys.
We'll try to get those guys up. I don't know. Maybe we could squeeze a few more.
Yeah, I'm sure.
We'll just pick some of the skinny ones.
Good luck.
Been to our shows? Come on.
Exactly.
That's true.
These are.
These are the skinny ones. You want to do a little Bobo Springsteen, a little Born to Run? He's been working on the song.
Well, he's been standing there like an idiot.
Should get this out of the way.
Him and David. Yeah.
All right.
Look, he's studying the words. You know this song? You know where the words go?
Yeah, I think I have an idea where some of the words go, right? Could someone point
some
out?
Of the words go? I have an idea where some of the words go. Interesting. That doesn't mean that means no. I don't know where
I
the words
go. I love
that
you guys printed out on 3-point Helvetica, too, just to make it harder.
Yeah.
Look at you font expert.
I am.
3-point Helvetica. all right. Yeah, you're studying the words. Enough studying. Singing time.
It's time.
All right, let's go.
All right, let's go with it.
Let's do this.
And you know, give it some passion, some excitement.
Okay,
all right?
Okay.
Don't be shy. Well, he's not shy.
No. Oh, no. Not yet. Ready?
Go!
In a day we sweat it out on the streets of the runway American dream. At the night we ride the mansion's a glorious suicide machine.
Suicide.
Sprung from cages out on Highway 9.
Uh-oh. He went. Now he's behind. Just go.
Chrome wheels injected stepping over the line. Baby, this town rips from your back. It's like a death trip and a suicide. We gotta get out of where we have to stress like us. Baby, we were born to run.
Wow, he caught up, I think.
Wendy, let me in.
No, not yet. Ready and go.
Wendy, let me in. I wanna be your friend. I wanna guard your dreams and visions. Just wrap your legs around these velvet rims. And destroyed your hands across my engine.
Oh, jeez. Back
together
up
we can break this trip. We're gonna run till we drop. Baby, we'll never go back. We will walk with me out the water. Cause baby, I'm just scared of the lonely rider. But I'm gonna find out what it feels like. I wanna know if love is wild and true. I wanna know if you know love is real. Beyond the dream.
No, not yet.
No, you gotta dance a little bit. No,
I think there's a solo or something.
Oh, man.
Fucking horn. Ooh, go good. Clarence.
Exactly.
Beyond the dream.
No.
Maybe I was born to dirt nap.
No, not yet.
I put a cue for that.
Ready?
Ready.
Go.
Beyond the palace, hemi power domes, extremes of the boulevard. The girl combs her hair in the rearview mirrors. And the boys try to look so hard. The amusement park for our choices, cold and stark. Kids are huddled onto the beach in the mist. I wanna die with you when Wendy on the streets and then an everlasting kiss.
Oh, you're kinda caught up.
The highway.
No! Big ending coming up, coming up. Ready?
Ready.
And
one, two, three,
go! The jammed with the broken heroes on the last.
No, now.
The highways were jammed with the broken heroes on the last chance to power drive. Everybody out to run tonight, but there's no place left to hide. Together, Wendy, we live with all the madness. I love you with all the madness in my soul. Someday, girl, I wanna know when we're gonna go to that place. What do we really want to go to? And well, we'll walk in the sun. But still, them like trans like us. Baby, we were born to run.
What the hell is this?
That's what he actually thinks as he's singing.
It's the Terry Schiavo cover.
Old macadamia brain.
Oh, David's dancing. Ends with the catch phrase thing.
Wow, that was they're in shock back there.
Oh, thank God, feedback.
Yeah,
I need my ears needed the refreshing sound of feedback after that. Yeah. Holy shit!
Oh my God!
Could you take the headphones away from the microphone?
That would help the situation.
Job. See, it makes like a circuit, and oh, forget it.
We can't hear you.
What? The thing was ringing in my ears.
It was ringing in everyone's ears.
Yeah, believe me.
Exactly.
Yeah, take the mic. Headphone. Why do you insist on putting a microphone next to the headphone?
What is wrong with you?
Keep the headphones away from the fucking microphone. Both of you. Holy shit.
I know. What are you, two idiots?
You guys. Well,
put the headphones on Matt. Pled
the case and it's over.
Someone must have put the headphones on max volume.
No, who's what Max Volume?
Who's Max Volume? Yeah.
No, they just turn the thing to the maximum decibel.
Why are you leaning down? Pick the microphone up. It's detachable.
The thing is,
then you were holding it right next to the mic, and it was feeding back. So then you gave it to David, who was then supposed to keep it from doing, and David put it right next to his mic.
What they did with the headphones is what they did in the beginning of Back to the Future when Marty just kept putting every dial to the highest thing possible.
Don't try to get on my good side.
That's what they did. Back to the Future reference,
my friend.
I was trying to think of a good comparison to that.
That's pretty much what it is,
and the thing pretty much, the headphones seemed like they were going to explode any minute now.
But it's all
any minute now.
Yes.
And then probably a couple, any minute now, lads, if a couple of us were going to go fly to the other end of the room.
Okay.
Two pea brains in a pod.
I got to go to Otto. Otto's taking this all in. I've never seen it.
You create these creatures.
It's amazing. Is Bobo's nose fake?
No.
Why does he sound like that?
Sinus problems, there, Bobo?
He's allergic to oxygen.
No, just spring allergies. Just spring allergies.
Spring allergies. A lot of people get that.
What are you allergic to, sweetie?
I'm just allergic. I'm just allergic to some kind of like high pollen count and stuff. Oh.
High pollen count.
Yeah.
I don't like that you took three or four words and made one. He doesn't realize he's not supposed to shove flowers up his nose.
It's up there. Sunflowers.
I'm allergic to pebbles here.
Yeah, that was impressive. Terrific. Yeah. Great.
Can you breathe out of your nose? Does any air come out of it?
Yeah, yeah, there's air coming out of it. There's air coming out of it right now.
Let me hear. Let me hear.
Unfortunately.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's great. Sounds like a Primatine Mist commercial.
Ah, David's pointing and laughing.
End of a big A date.
David, you're having a ball, aren't you?
Yes. Yeah, David, when did David become the normal one?
I was like, David's become Bobo's lackey. Like, you just sit there and point and laugh at him. You're kind of just like his lackey now.
You're the Bud Abbott of this team, hasn't
you? Yeah, you used to be like the guy that was in charge.
Yeah, you're Bobo's manager now, you Jew.
Something like that, yeah.
Jew.
Something like that, yeah.
What happened? When did your stars start falling?
I didn't. I'm just laughing at Bobo. He's very funny today.
Just love leaving him hang like that.
It's so uncomfortable.
Ladies and gentlemen, David being David.
What's that?
David being David.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which one of you do you think is the star of the radio team?
Fucking idiot. Well, Bobo calls him intern David, so.
Yeah. I think Bobo is the star.
Wow, look at that. You're able to step aside.
I like that. A little humility.
And,
yeah. Cool. Mm.
Have you you worked the crowd at all there, David? You're going to be doing that? Maybe find some interesting stories that people have? We got a lot of people.
Yeah,
I would assume there's,
You know what he should do? He should work the crowd outside.
And
five people that have really good stories,
and
you bring them up.
Upstairs into
you
the
bring them up. That's what you do, David.
Okay.
You give them the golden ticket.
Yep.
All right.
The big invite.
Sounds good.
But by the way, I have to give a big... I have to give a big FU to Best Buy. I went to Best Buy to buy a home kit.
Say bye again.
I'm showing up there wearing.
Where?
You know you can use your nose,
Best
right?
Best Buy in Queens Boulevard.
I know.
Best Buy in Queens Boulevard. He never says something is on a street, like on the turnpike. He goes in. In Queens Boulevard.
Best Buy.
Best
Buy in
Best
Queens.
Best Buy in Queens Boulevard.
It's right. In 47th Street.
Yeah. He's a fucking Con Ed worker.
I was showing up there where... I was wearing a Funkus shirt trying to buy a home kit.
A home kit? What's that?
The
home kit for
thanks, Dan.
The thing for the new XM I got last week.
Oh, that's right.
We got a nice okay. I don't automatically think everything XM. Yeah. When you say home kit, I'm like, suicide.
It's a fucking garden hose that comes with a curl built into it.
A Gavorkian home kit.
All right, you just go, Bubba. We're just actors in your play.
Yes. So you went in, and what happened? You had a Frunkus shirt on.
Yeah, and then I asked the guy if they have it right, and he's like looking, and I could tell by look at this guy that this guy was an idiotic ho ho fan, knew who I was.
Ho ho
fan.
That's Santa Claus.
Wait, I got out of breath listening to him.
He was an idiot who knew who you were. That was a mirror.
I could tell he kind of knew who he was. The guy was an evil alternate universe version of E-Rock.
Oh, okay. Yeah. We were banging our heads on this one. We'll just leave the jokes to you people.
Yeah.
Skinny, smart, competent.
Minty
mouthed.
Healthy eater.
E-Rock.
Yes. Non-pelican neck. You go right ahead. Bobo the Tank.
I'll change the name on the signs. It's his show now.
Go ahead, Bobo.
I mean, interrupt you.
So what happened, Bobo?
The guy looked like
how does this fucking
end? The guy was hairier than Hagrid. In Harry Potter, the guy, the giant, he was hairier than this guy.
Good reference.
Wait, what was his name again?
What, that giant in Harry Potter? Hagrid.
Okay.
This guy looked hairier than him.
Whatever.
And this guy seemed like the evil alternate universe version of E-Rock.
Really?
We don't have it. We might get more in the truck on Thursday. And I says, and I was like thinking in my head, this guy's obvious just trying to not sell me it. Because they got a freaking million serious stuff. And this guy's obviously a stern fit. I can tell by the look at his face.
He sounds like he should be 800 pounds. Just in a bed eating ho-hos.
This guy would have been...
Oh, David keeps hushing.
Oh, David.
Hey, David, what are you doing?
No, because he was interrupting Bob.
Yeah. No, keep going, Bobo.
Bob Kelly says something, so I'm waiting for him. When Bob Kelly talks, I'm telling Bobo not to talk.
Oh, that's good. So when Bob Kelly was finished, then you went over and told Bobo to stop talking.
Right, so there's total silence.
Good job.
It's either a clusterfuck or you can hear a pin drop.
He's not taking my directions very well.
No, huh?
Oh, that's got to piss you off, huh?
Wow.
Did he finish the story, Bobo? I don't know.
No, he didn't.
I said, if Anthony was here, I think he would have got this guy with one of his guns.
Oh, yeah, because I just love shooting up electronic stores.
Yeah, because he's that's what a responsible gun owner does.
Yes.
Wow.
Hey, Sam.
All that.
What's going on the street?
They're clamoring for prizes. There's a lot of people out there.
Well, David is going to work the crowd, and the five best stories, he's going to bring them up.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Hey, give him my iPhone. Give it away.
Okay.
Are you out of your mind?
Yeah.
I don't like Sam's new look, by the way.
What the do? Yeah,
well, no, the beard. It, the Bob. Fucking beard.
Holy
now he's trying.
Shit.
Now he's got the beard. He's trying to hide me, and I don't like it.
He doesn't want to be a boyish face twink anymore for you.
You know what happened, Bob?
What's up, baby?
It was all fun and games.
Right.
But then the attempted rape was like...
Yeah. We saw that picture, man.
I didn't attempt it.
You
were trying to pull his fucking pants down with one hand from the back.
Slow down. Go ahead. Yeah. Say it again.
You had your hand wedged in the fucking... The back of his pants.
Yeah.
And as you were pulling them down slowly, I could see Bob's fingers scraping over the top of Sam's crack.
Yeah, you probably smelt ass on your fingers.
It was like
when you
eat the cheese doodles and your fingers are all like... orange after
cheesy,
and then you lick them. Nice little Sam boy ass.
You are disgusting.
I'll fucking get you now. Watch.
No more for
I'm gonna
you
come
now.
Right in your
no
beard.
No more for you now. No.
Oh, you ever try to get cum out of a beard? It's really hard. Yes.
Jesus, Bobby.
I like Jim's quick response. Yes, sir. I'm gonna get you, Sam. I'm gonna get you.
I'll stab you.
I'm gonna get you. Stab me. Go ahead, fight. That's what I want. That's what I want. I want you to fight.
You just want it easy, there. Sam.
I don't. I want to fucking wrap you with a belt right around your neck and carry you around this fucking studio. I'll do it right now.
I will wreck you.
Really?
I will.
You'll wreck me?
I'll wreck you.
Like how wreck me?
I'll destroy your world.
Really? Yeah.
Go ahead,
that's
Bobby.
What I want.
Go
you ahead, want, you want? Is
this is prime time. Sam Roberts talking right now.
Go ahead.
He's work. He's doing some mic work now.
Okay, Sam.
Prime time.
Oh, you know what? I'm not gonna play this game. I can't. I don't want to hurt him. Sam, I'd never do that to you.
You're gonna get a fame asser.
Right.
Fame asser. Yeah, you almost got one. Oh shit.
Oh shit. They're fighting. They're fighting.
Bobby's got. Look at how Bobby's dominating.
Bobby's dominating.
Bobby's on
top. Bobby's 100%. Bobby's 100%. Sam is helpless.
He's dominating.
What is he doing now? Uh-oh. He left him on the floor.
What happened, Sam? You're
I
right?
don't know.
Somebody call the cops on that.
What happened, Sam?
Nothing. Didn't anything? Nothing happened.
I'm gonna cry in the
nothing
shower.
Nothing happened here. Nothing happened here.
But
now I have to go down on the street to give some people some prizes.
I hope you get raped again.
Jesus.
You would let me do my job.
Nothing happened there, right?
Nothing happened here.
So you want everyone to erase what they just shot on their cameras.
I came
all
here.
All the pictures that are going to be there.
I
that'll
got
straighten
prizes.
Your fucking feet out.
Oh, look at his hair. It's all over the place.
Oh, my God. It's coming out of his ponytail.
Jesus, Bobby.
My you ravaged them.
He looks like fucking Leon from Dog Day Afternoon.
Oh, yeah. Wasn't it upsetting what a high arc Bobby uses when he fucks? Your ass was like really
I
fucking
have to.
Moving.
I have less cock than you.
You're going to fuck up your
you
lower back
doing a really,
with that motion.
Huh?
Some you were doing a high ass.
Yeah,
really pounding.
Yeah, I got less dick.
Power fucking.
I have to take it out and push it back in.
Sam, you need the rape kit.
Just imagine my dick is still in you.
Yeah, exactly. You have to imagine 3 inches and still in you, and then I push it back in.
And you're barely out of breath. Look at that. You're a new man, Bobby.
Well,
I used to knock you out.
So so is Sam.
Sam's a new man too.
Yeah.
I'm not a new man.
Sam, hey, what?
Nothing happened.
Jesus.
Yeah, it was just, you were hanging out.
That's I came here, got some too. Prizes, yeah. And now I'm on my way back downstairs.
Happy right. place.
Sam, why don't you hand out the gifts we got for everybody, the little snacks.
Oh!
See, look at this.
That'll distract everybody for a little while.
Wow! And make believe what we see got a man here? On man rape.
For coming on the Opie and Anthony show today.
That should be me then.
Yeah.
Bobby.
I don't know what he's talking about.
Yeah.
You all get to join us. For animal crackers and juice boxes.
Yay! Courtesy of the Opie and Anthony Show.
How nice.
Everyone loves cookies and juice.
Oh, juice.
Yeah, I heard that too. David is handing out the
animal
the juice
crackers.
Boxes.
The those animal are the crackers. Little animal crackers. Remember those? They come in a little cage thing. I like getting the one in there that's of the elephant man. You bite his big giant head off. Nothing. Wow. Holy shit. I wasn't even waiting for something on that one. Oof. See, it's animal crackers.
I was fucking tweeting something.
Thank God. Thank God. I dropped what is known as, I believe it was called Little Boy. Holy shit.
I heard it.
Of course you did. Yeah, hump.
I see Sonny Forelli in the audience.
Yay!
Some familiar faces.
Oh, Bobo's working the girls. Oh, Bobo, Bobo's yeah. working.
Who are you working, Bobo?
Oh, look, he's working his chick.
Is that
the
your
one
chick?
That he chats with?
That's his girlfriend right there, the blonde?
Yeah,
no.
We text every so often.
Ooh.
Yeah?
The text bill's probably going to be a lot.
How are you going to pay for that?
Hmm.
I don't know yet, but I am gonna have to have people pay me in it. Everybody in Maspeth that runs into me,
yeah.
If they want it, if they see me on the subway or the bus and say, "Hey Bobo, say sing a Springsteen song about me." They're going to have to pay me.
He wants money now.
You know what? It's not a bad idea.
That's if they run into me on the street. And anywhere here, it's free. But if they have if they run into me at random.
Right, we get it.
And dude, anywhere other you should, than City Field.
You should wear an I Am Bobo hat or something.
Yeah. We should set this up now on the street somewhere. Random. Bobo Springsteen songs for people.
Yeah, and then they got to pay him.
Yeah, you should do that, and I should wear like an ONA hoodie.
Well,
should
if we had ONA,
trying to get swag out of the deal.
Yeah, exactly.
No, he's really working.
They don't
this.
Have him anymore.
Yeah, I see Bobby's sporting a really nice Sirius hoodie though.
Yeah, I got this when I did the Sirius shows over there.
Yeah.
Now,
nice. More than we're getting.
Girl that was known as Hot Chick. Wasn't David? Getting in touch with you?
Ah.
I work the crowd.
And now Bobo is getting in touch with you?
I can't, you know my ways. I'm a little...
David, how do you feel? How do you feel that Bobo is trying to fucking hone in on your chick?
I don't know, I'm a little upset. I don't like that.
Bros before hoes.
Wait, David, who has a better shot with her?
I don't even know if Bobo knows her real name.
Ooh.
Oh, wow.
That's fucked up.
Her name is Leah.
Ooh.
Well, what did you think her name was originally?
See, I don't know. She was drunk when she gave me her cell number.
No shit.
Really?
She put Vanessa in her name.
Well, maybe she just did that.
Yeah, exactly.
She put Vanessa in the name and gave me the wrong number.
Yeah.
it was the right number, but she
apparently she lives at the Home Depot.
Yes. It was only one number. I'm like, you're an operator?
She put the wrong name.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
By the way,
you thought "fuck off, stupid" was a name.
By the way, that day, my neighbor asked me to join him at a Connolly's Corner in my neighborhood.
Okay.
And I wound up getting even more drunk that night.
Oh wow!
Oh, you're a drinker, Bobo.
Yeah, yeah.
Why don't your glasses fog up when you speak?
I only drink on certain occasions.
And that day was one of them.
Jesus Christ. I should write a book.
So now you two, is there... Jesus. Wow, you can attract them. So how is this getting resolved? Are you...
Well, he knows me as Vanessa Huxtable, but actually...
Is that who you said you are?
That's who I said I was.
Yeah, that's great, Jesus. And he bought that.
Wow. Do you realize that the three people that have crushes on her are David, Bobo, and Rich Voss?
Wow. Yeah, yeah.
Wow. Have more of a chance. You have teeth.
Nice.
And he's smarter. And he can breathe. He can breathe better.
Yeah. I have a present for you. I didn't come empty-handed.
Wow.
A present for Bobo and not David.
No, it's for Bobo.
Oh, David!
What's that about, Bobo?
Bobo, are you excited?
What's that about? You get a gift and I don't, Bobo.
Yes, this is where my affections lie. Here.
All right.
Let's see what it is, Bobo.
Open that up, Bobo.
Bobo, what'd you get, Bobo?
It's a handgun with a mirror on it.
Oh, what is it?
Oh, shit.
Oh, a wallet.
Listen.
With security.
Is that from the...
Wait, but we gotta explain what's on the wallet.
Well, supposedly it's a leather wallet, and there's like...
Supposedly. I have to have it authenticated.
That's the case for the wallet.
That's not your grandfather's wallet. It's the new shiny 20th century ACM wallet.
Wow.
What kind of a logo is on the wallet there, Bobo?
It's got the Mets logo.
And what's the electronics that are in there?
It says something like hands, the credit card, the Visa, ATM. Yeah.
You put your credit cards in there, and when you push the button, one pops out.
It's from the Air Mall magazine.
And it has the New York Mets logo on his favorite baseball team.
Oh. Really? No one knew that.
Bobo.
Whoa. As advertised in Maxim and Esquire, and actually, my dad invented it, so I'm totally plugging my pops.
He did really?
For real?
He invented that?
Yeah.
I've always wanted one of those.
He invented the wallet.
Your father invented the concept of the wallet?
Is he Jewish? The ACM wallet. Yeah.
Before that, people just carried change in their mouths.
the one with the credit cards that
pop
can
out.
Go in. Huh?
Yeah, you push a button.
They're in the Sky Mall catalog.
Yeah.
How does that work?
It might take you a while to figure it out, so I'll just let you play it.
Oh, believe me, get a credit card. You ain't going to...
Yeah.
Has your dad made money off this invention?
Yeah, he's done pretty well. It's in Maxim every month.
How does it work, Leah?
You just push a button.
Why'd you give Bobo a complicated wallet, though?
I know. If we got Norton one, can we put a tranny on one of the buttons?
Eventually, I'll figure this thing out.
Sorry, hang on.
Eventually, you'll figure this thing out. What life?
By next week, I'll have this wallet figured out.
He'll pop in a slice of pizza, will fly out.
I'll never figure out Vista, though.
What?
Well, yes.
A Windows Vista.
What other Vista could there be, David?
Jesus.
My uncle's laptop crashed when he installed it.
His laptop?
Laptop. Yeah.
That's
a
laptop that has milk coming out of it.
and neither my cousin who knows computers figured it out either. My oldest cousin, not the one who damaged the XM. The oldest one is responsible.
Have you thanked Vanessa Huxtable?
Training.
Yeah, I said thanks.
Oh, I didn't hear that.
I didn't hear thank you either.
Thanks for the wallet.
You're welcome. I'll help you work it. I'll push some buttons for you.
Wow. Whoa! I see a budding little romance here, Bobo.
How are you feeling right now, Bobo?
This feels great.
Yeah?
You'll feel better when I push the buttons.
You getting a little boner?
You sure there's not a restraining order in that box, too?
Of course.
Of course.
Let me go to Charlie.
Jesus Christ.
Charlie, what's up?
What's up, Bobo boys?
Hey, Charlie.
Hey, Bobo.
Yeah?
Hey, Bobo, can we get you to say, I will gladly pay you Tuesday for a hamburger today?
He does sound like wimpy.
Later, boys.
All right. Well, he requested a wimpy impersonation.
Yeah.
I'll do it. I will gladly pay you Tuesday for a hamburger today.
Boo!
All right. Jesus.
Otto, aren't you glad you came in today?
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what he looks like to me.
You should have brought in George.
Oh, my God. Holy shit.
Look at the shape of his head and forgive him.
me
me and one of my cousins the other day was laughing at one of your DVDs.
The case or the did you?
We watched the DVD.
Oh, thank you.
We watched it.
I love how this guy's answer punchlines.
We put the disc in a player and we watched it.
Thank you. Go Mets.
Go Mets.
All right, Bobo. Why don't we say hi to Pat from Menaki? You taking this all in there, Pat?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? What's your observation so far? What do you got?
It's a great day. It reminds me of the first time I came here for the cherry darts.
Ah.
Wow.
That was like first couple days you were here. And now a chapter is closing.
Wow.
I was having fun with the animal crackers. I'm on my diet. I can't eat them, but I was recreating Armageddon scene.
Oh, no.
Look at these. Oh. He's using his stomach.
You got to do his little speech.
Yeah.
Drink out of the well.
He's got the animal crackers on his stomach.
His stomach looks like Google Map.
Google Earth. I have a talent. I did have a talent for the variety show. Was
really?
It in the tradition of good radio.
Tradition?
I was gonna juggle.
Oh, you were going to juggle?
Yeah, I didn't have time to practice. I used to be able to juggle, but
what are you going to juggle?
Let's see him juggle.
I think the racquetballs.
Let's get some knives.
Yeah. I tried that once. Yeah. And then my toe came up.
Yes. That's how you gonna juggle one toe and two cubes of sugar. Aren't you?
Thanks. Did Kenny tell you that there wasn't enough room in here for humor?
Yeah.
Apparently not.
Yeah, there is none.
Apparently there isn't.
Haboo.
That's why it's roomy in here now.
Ooh. Wow. Why don't you try juggling with iced coffee?
Fucking, like the Tet Offensive in here.
Wow. Go ahead, Bobby.
You know how to bring the room up there. Why don't you juggle a little bit?
You might as well.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, here comes...
Because we were going to do a little variety show thing.
We just don't have...
Oh,
I like the music.
We got the music. Sounds like Wonderama.
Travis, working that board, doing a good job so far, man.
He knows he's got to fucking do a good job.
Want me to do it on the unicycle? Oh.
You might want to move back, Pat. Don't you need some air?
Yeah, okay.
There you go.
But I want to...
The ceiling's a little high.
That'll be all
right. Right here, this is good enough.
All right, here goes
Pat. Here we go, careful.
Juggling on the radio.
Get out of the way, Sam.
This is our next
three red balls, there he goes.
It's not very light in here.
No, not with you in here, it's not.
Oh, he's chasing one of the balls
He's
around.
Chasing him around now.
Yeah, it's good.
Okay,
God.
He's chasing like he's chasing his father.
He's got him. Wow, what a parlor trick.
That's,
It's good.
That looks tiring for you.
I'll eat one of them like an apple.
Yeah, an apple. When was the last time you ate an apple?
The computer recently.
That's great.
The only thing worse than juggling on the radio is having to see it, too.
Yeah, it really is awful.
All right.
We're trying to bring back radio from Pat. The 30s. If anyone else has just do awful things like this show.
Yeah.
If anyone else has a skill, let Sam know. David, you got to go downstairs and get five more people up here. You decide.
I thought he had done that.
I know, he should have left like 20 minutes
ago. David, you're standing up here enjoying the program. You go right ahead, Bobo.
Bobo doesn't have a mic, and he's just talking. He's
and
yelling.
Thin air.
I was going to say, tell Fuckwad to juggle Pat.
Good thing you didn't say that. It would have bombed.
Fuck what the clown when Eastside Dave was wearing that clown outfit.
All right, then just say it and explain it.
Fuck twat, right?
Yeah.
Well, not if you're Bobo. It's fuck what.
Fuck what.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. I thought fuck what sounds better.
Oh, so change his character name.
Okay.
That he's developed. That's good. All right. If anyone else has a skill, let us know. David,
anyone else? How about if anyone has a skill? It implies that we've seen skills so far.
There's no skill whatsoever
in Patty,
this room.
Patty, what do you bring for the big show? Because we were going to do like an all-out variety show.
There's a 1920s song that plays called In the Mood, and I could do one of the dances that
Is it your prom song?
It.
Get it, because she's old.
Another visual bit for
everybody. I make everybody in the store laugh when I do it there.
Oh, really? Yeah.
All right, get up front. Let's see it real fast.
So they point and laugh.
I don't even know if we have the
throw tampons at you and say, plug it up, plug it up.
Patty, you're talking to thin air. There's a microphone.
Right there, a mic in front.
What is with people?
I don't know.
It's a radio show.
This is not magic.
Yeah, we got to talk into the electric thing.
All right, I'll do it. I'll just do the motions, okay?
You're still not near the microphone,
oh
Patty.
Oh, my
Jesus
God.
Christ.
Is she a retard?
Well, it's a dance, not a song, though.
Yeah, but she's trying to say what she's going to do, and she's saying
it's
into nowhere.
It's sort of like a 1920s dance, so I do it, and people laugh when I do it.
Is it like a flapper dance?
Yes. Sort of, yeah. I'm pretty good at it, too.
Oh, wow, she's modest. This is gonna be so bad. Hold on, Patty. Don't do it yet.
I bet she's good, Ann, to be honest.
Capture this and put it on Shitter.
You mean Tweeter.
Yeah. Oh, that's it. Oh.
Why do they answer the punchline?
I don't know.
It's my new favorite
incomprehensible.
Just amazing punchlines they answer.
I've never seen people so not understand humor in my life.
Fucking,
listen to the show for 10 years.
The laughter just stops instantly.
They jump on jokes like it's the fucking Family Feud button. Punchline.
I would love to hear what they hear in their heads when they're listening to this show.
Yeah.
Because I bet it's very, very different.
A buzzing drone.
It's that sound you hear when a mosquito go by your ear. Right. She hears that all the time. Mm.
Go by your ear?
You got the music? What'd I say?
How much?
When a mosquito goes by your ear.
Yes, if your ear's for sale.
A 10-year emporium.
Yes. I have all kinds of ears. Except for those of the burn victims. They're just kind of small circles. Nobody buys them.
All right, Patty. Let's see yours.
I think we got a song for Patty, so she can do the dance for everybody.
Oh, God.
Oh, shit.
We'll try to describe the dance for the radio audience. That she does. Here's the song.
All right. She can't clip the fucking wireless thing on her.
She's got tranny hips.
Yeah.
God.
All right.
I have arthritis.
Here she goes.
All right.
Go to the crowd. Turn around for the crowd.
Okay.
Here we go.
This is sad. You know she did this for a dad.
Will you fucking dance? More. Come on, varmint.
No, she's waiting for her.
Daddy, look what I learned for you. And then he just threw a beer at her head.
Oh, she's fucking. That's good, actually. You are pretty good at it.
What is that, the Charleston Chew?
No, that's what people were looking at in that last shot at the Overlook Hotel.
Yeah. That's what they were watching.
After she got out of the bathtub.
The deleted scene after she cleaned up and got dressed.
The director's cunt.
All right, you're gonna do it all day.
I know. It's the same flailing movement. It's great.
You should let her do it until she can't do it anymore.
Yeah.
The whole show, just let her do that.
That's great.
I don't know whether it's the Lindy or what, but I learned it from watching something late night.
The
on TV.
Lindy.
All right. Well, no one reacted to your dance.
That was terrible.
It was horrendous.
Again, no talent whatsoever. Shit.
I liked it.
After she got out of the tub.
It's hard for you to do the wavy legs? Why is that?
How do you do it?
It's just hard for me to do it because I have arthritis of the knees. So
why do you call
it? I did it. It's amazing. Great.
Do it. Yeah, it was amazing.
Yeah.
Do it again. Let me see what.
Let's see the wavy legs.
There's the wavy.
That
legs.
Isn't even the way they do it.
No.
You got to put your hands on your knees and then cross them over as you slap your knees together.
When she does that,
cross them over. Cross your hands over.
Cross your
Bend
hands
your
over.
Knees together and then do that. Yeah. Now go back out and go now back in. And now kill yourself. I was hoping she'd get caught up in the whole thing.
Her vagina unhinges like a snake's jaw.
That was great, Patty.
Yeah, very good.
Ugh.
Where'd she go? Oh, she's hiding behind the black guy.
All right, why don't we take a break?
Fucking calcium deposit knees.
Yeah, she has fucking old knee goiters.
We got a Kenny update. Kenny?
There's a lot of people standing outside in the rain. So are there any good-hearted people that want to have good karma and maybe give up their spot for somebody else?
Wow. Maybe you should have presented it like, is anybody, does anybody have to go to work soon?
No!
What?
Whose audience do you think this is?
I know, that's true.
Does anyone work. Have jobs here?
No!
All right. Well, that's not happening, Kenny. So we got Robert Kelly in studio, robertkellylive.com.
Yeah, I'm going to be at the Cannabis Festival the 20th April at
Cannabis
the
Festival.
Cannabis. I don't know. I don't
cannabis.
Smoke weed.
Did you say cannabis?
I don't know.
Cannabis.
I haven't smoked weed in 24 years.
Right, but you still know what it's called, though. Yeah.
Fucking dope. Yeah. Drugs, weed, fucking 420. Bang.
I know. I used to smoke put.
April 20th at the Blender Theater. Big show.
All right. And Otto's got the big show tonight and tomorrow.
Yeah.
Sayreville.
7:30 tonight.
What is it called? Primetime Comedy Club?
Yes, it is.
Ooh. Sayreville, New Jersey. Ooh. All right.
It's a gorgeous club, I heard.
Yeah. It's very state of the art.
Yeah. 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 I'm in Bananas in Poughkeepsie tonight. We're leaving shortly.
Poughkeepsie.
After the show. Right now.
Well,
yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, you know.
Well, you know, leave now. I'll be traveling. Jersey, 280.
Right. You know, I hope the crowd shows up, you know, folks.
You know how it is sometimes.
It's like the Democrats versus the Republicans up there sometimes.
All right. Bin Laden.
I do have my earlobes now the size of an elephant, but that's okay.
Oh, we got Bob Saget coming in, too.
Oh, wow. Fuck yeah.
What'd you call
Jesus
me?
Jesus Christ.
Bob Saget. He's got another fucking show on TV. Amazing, this Bob Saget. We'll find out about it in a few. True I don't know, boogie. 9:30 or something like
10:30,
that?
10:30, I think, or 10.
10? We ain't going to be here at 10:30.
At 10.
All right, 10 o'clock's good.
Good luck.
True Boogie, play us out for a little bit.
Go home and get your fucking shine box. He's just kid a little fucking manage. He's just kid a little fucking manage. Come on. He's just kid a little fucking manage. Come on. Go home and get your fucking shine box. Shine box.
Good morning. Good morning.
Nice. Let's hear it for Drew Boogie doing a good job today for us. Okay, Anthony. Live from the XM studio. In a little over a week, it becomes the Sirius XM studio in the big building. Where is that place?
When's that XM part just getting cut off?
48th and 6th.
48 and 6th?
48th, 49th, and 6th.
Because all our stalkers need to know the new address to stalk us out.
So. Yeah.
You can get in from both sides of the building on 48th and 49th.
Wow, you really know the place.
Sure do.
Bob Kelly.
Yes.
Tweeting celebrities.
Yeah, not anymore, you guys. Fucking
tweeting celebrities. Oh. Pass them out.
Let me tell you something. I deserve every fucking
pass
second of it.
Did you get a beating?
Oh my God, did I deserve it?
Someone brought it to our attention that you were tweeting the celebrities out there.
I just want a friend.
Hey, Favreau.
Oh, it's terrible.
That's one of my favorites.
Let me tell you one thing.
But can you see? Can you just notice, though, that it starts out strong and then it slowly dies?
Oh, yeah. I see the last one is perfect.
If I see, hey, Favreau here, I'm going to fucking lean over and bite Bob Kelly's cheek.
Oh, wow. I'm excited.
Hey, Jimmy, I think this is yours, man. I think you need to run through these in front of Bob.
Oh, yeah. These are real tweets
that Bob Kelly sent out to celebrities.
This is
the ones we caught, by the way. Who knows who else?
No. They're all up there. This is the... I'll admit to you. This... And I'm glad you guys really had an intervention with me and smashed me.
Yeah.
Because it really snapped me out of it. Because what happens is I'm I see these famous people.
Yeah.
And I thought maybe, you know, maybe I say hi and he'd be like, hey, what's up, man? It's almost like, when you see celebrities out and you might, you run up and you want to take a photo with them.
You know what I mean? Like when, you know, let me get a photo with that
guy.
Oh,
so you're virtually asking them for a photo, pretty
much. Yeah, think, you know when you get your photos done, you think maybe he go, Jim Norton.
Yes.
He'd be like, hey, how you doing?
You're looking for some validation, like Jimmy Fallon will write back and go, hey, Bobby, what's been on? I haven't seen you in a while.
Never happened.
No, why would it?
Never happened.
All right, okay. Jimmy, run through these, please.
Here's some of Bob Kelly's repulsive celebrity tweets.
Are these in order, though?
Oh, God, I'm reading.
What order could they be in? From shitty to embarrassing to awful?
What are they? What did you call them? Repulsive celebrity tweets?
We got some of the better ones,
Bobby. That should be a new show on the show.
I would think you drank. And these were drunk tweets.
You're gonna understand. I'm in
late night tweeting.
This is me lonely on the road. Yeah. 5 days out of the week of last month. I'm home maybe a day in Kansas City, 2 a.m. I don't drink. I don't use drugs. I don't eat food. I don't fuck whores. I just want a friend. I just want to hug Anthony.
Yeah, here's one.
3 p.m., 11:15 p.m., like I said, 10:50 a.m.
So I have different hours. 7:30
p.m.
That's midnight for me.
This isn't 4 in the morning.
No, that's mid. I am a comic. That's 4 in the morning to me.
All right. Here we go.
You bought that?
At Jimmy Fallon.
No.
Yes. Nothing.
Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah. Bobby wrote.
Here we go.
Can't wait for the show tonight.
Like the show.
That's it. Can't wait for the show tonight.
Why can't you wait?
Yeah. Why did you have to tell him?
I figured if I wrote that, like, hey, man, I'd be supportive, then he would say, that's Bob Kelly. I know him. And then he'd go, hey, man, thanks a lot. I didn't know you were on this. Yeah, I am, too. This is what's going on in my head.
You wanna hear?
Wait. It goes further. Yeah, I am, man.
Stab him in the chest when he opens the door? This is such fucking stalker shit.
Oh, it's bad. Yeah. Go ahead. Keep going. It gets worse.
There's another one. At Jimmy Fallon.
I think I got deleted from it. I deleted every famous person. All of them are gone.
Cool. Now this is good because now you're trying to make a little contact with your wit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is good. This is good. Yeah. I actually like this one.
Right.
Go ahead.
Great show, Jimmy. I didn't know Joaquin Phoenix was on the show. Oh, wait. That was Robert De Niro.
Oh.
You thought he was going to... Now, what was going through your head here? He reads it. He goes, oh, my God, that's funny.
And then,
at first, he goes, wait, Joaquin Phoenix
wasn't
on...
That's
funny.
Do you want to hear what's going through the head?
Yeah.
Okay, honestly...
Unfortunately, not a bullet.
That was good. Honestly?
Yeah.
Okay, here it goes. Hey, Bob Kelly again. What's up, man? Oh, I get it. That was the dude. Do you write, dude? Do you write?
Oh, no.
Well, a little bit, not too much. Well, dude, why don't you come down, man? And you know that was a good one. I got a fax. Maybe you could write some stuff. You ever think of anything? It only pays like $75 a joke, but you know, who knows what
do
it
you
leads
go?
To.
Do you go as far to the point of like as he's accepting his Emmy? The writers are up there, and you're up there, and you lean over and go, "I didn't think this would start with a Twitter
Emmy."
But
I don't want
to
fucking. I don't want a broad. I want a dude.
You want the Oscar?
Yeah. Well, you fucking shoot for an Emmy. Fuck
not
that.
Getting, you're not getting a pile of dog shit. Steaming dog shit.
Really?
Really.
I know. You're saying that like I don't know that. Yes, I know that.
You're tweeting it like you don't know that.
Yay, great show.
You were denying an Emmy. You were not accepting the Emmy.
Well, if I'm going to fantasize, why not? Why fantasize about the big one? Why am I going to fantasize about an Emmy? I don't want to be up there with House. We up there with fucking the big ones.
Go to the John.
Oh, shit.
No
fat jokes. That stinks.
Go to the
I'm
John
sorry.
Favreau.
I apologize, Norton. Go ahead.
What? No, I was actually going to go into because you look better
first,
now.
Yeah, first, John Favreau.
Yeah.
Just to let you know this, I'll be honest. I met him in Aspen.
Yeah.
He walks up to me, hey, man, and I'm pretty sure he thought I was you because we're both bald and we both wear hoodies sometimes.
Yeah.
And he walked, hey, big fan. And I'm like, really? He's like, yeah, man. Yeah, I love you on that show, Tough Crowd, which I was on like maybe 10 times. You were a regular on every week.
Oh, boy.
So I literally took your compliment.
Hold on, Bobby.
I took your compliment.
Hold on, Bobby. Bobo has a problem.
What are you talking about? You're just babbling.
I got something to say about David. David, when your internship is up, you won't be missed. You can be easily replaced. I just found the best replacement for you, Robert Kelly.
All right, at least it was worth it.
He just started yapping in the corner with no microphone. Yeah.
And you can't really hear it on the air, but off the air, you kind of hear it. Yeah, you hear this little...
Does he know that you're supposed to take breaths inside of sentences? Like, you're supposed to breathe as you talk?
No.
Breathe.
David,
breathe,
response?
Breathe.
Well, it is ending in May, so they do need a replacement for me. It is true.
Yeah.
Wow. All right, get back to me.
All right, we're going to back to
get back to trashing me.
By the way, David brought five people up from the street. We're going to find out which five people and why in a minute or two. But back to Robert.
I met Favreau in I think it was the card thing that we went to. Remember we went to California and they played cards.
Tournament. Yeah, sure.
He actually came up to me there and said he was a big tough guy.
Yeah, he's
fan.
A poker player.
I as soon as you said that, I'm like, there's no way you're a fan of mine. In my head, but then I took the compliment anyways. All
right.
John Favreau. Here's a good tweet.
This is Bob's tweet to John Favreau.
Hey, buddy.
Because he got the compliment, so he's probably thinking, look.
Well, no. I got the compliment. I was half thinking you, but then there was a little hope. Maybe
right.
It was.
Well, this is why you gave this tweet.
This is the hope. This is the other half of the hope.
What's up, John? How's things going, bro?
Exactly.
Bro, and just how things going?
But I didn't really understand how tweet works but at that time, too. But that's no excuse. Go ahead.
Why? What do you mean? You didn't know other people could see this?
No. You can't. I knew that, like, my followers. But I didn't know, like, everybody.
Everybody.
And then it's just there. You know what I mean?
Just sits there.
Yeah. But it's also, hey, what's up, man? It's also, but go ahead. You're absolutely, I am not fighting any of this. I've deleted every famous person. I do not. All right. I was. It was
Let's
awful.
Let's go through the John Favreau tweet.
Keep
before.
Going.
Wow, you are really backpedaling.
No, I'm not. I'm fucking accepting this smashing.
I don't
go ahead.
I accept. I don't understand this next one.
Yeah.
Let me explain it if I can.
Well.
I don't have my own fucking tweets. Could somebody make them available?
No. You're Jimmy's getting.
These, I don't want them. All right, cut.
Unprepared. Leave them unprepared.
Look at Danny just stopping midair. What did Boss say?
Shall I read the next one?
Sure.
It's at John Favreau.
Let Anthony read one.
Anthony, you want to read one?
When are you going to tweet some pictures for us, John? Dude.
What?
All right. Now,
first of all, why are you tweeting him again?
Right, exactly.
Because he never answered you.
Did he tell you what's up?
Yeah.
And your grammar in this is horrible. What's up, John? How's things going?
Oh, come on, dude. Of course it is.
How is things going?
It's awful.
It's how are things going?
Dude, you, two. I don't know what the fuck it is.
All right. And then he must have said, great, Bob. What else you want to know?
And then I said.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
When are you going to tweet some pics for us, John?
And then he said. What's your personal email so I can just send them directly to you, Bob?
Ah, sure. Why did you want pictures? What pictures were you expecting?
He was actually posting all these things about his place, like all this stuff, about his house. And then I was like, well, fucking put some photos up. He was telling us all this stuff, I think, of like memorabilia he has, some shit like that, at his house. So I was like, when are you going to throw some fucking pics? Oh, no, it was Gwyneth. He was rehearsing with Gwyneth Paltrow. Is what it was.
You want and in with this so bad.
Wants in with anybody so
anybody.
Bad.
Anybody.
Yeah.
Anybody.
He's talking about Gwyneth Paltrow and his tweets.
Yeah.
And he's talking about his hat. And you just want to dive into the conversation and be like. And did he type back, not you?
I wish he did. I really just want
a
new circle of friends.
Someone that wants to be loved.
The next one.
I just want to be hugged, well, Anthony.
The next one, actually, I had a physical reaction to.
Really?
Like what?
Like boo.
Like,
yeah, that'd be it.
Oh,
internally,
my
chest hurt, and I heard boo.
Jimmy, take
right,
it.
Let's
then.
Go.
Take
let's
it
go.
Then.
Jimmy, you do it.
At John Favreau, I guess the twit pick was a red carpet. And I do like when the jokes fly. The only way I would ever be on a red carpet is if someone shot me on a white carpet.
Wait.
Oh.
Wait, now, everybody, I want you to stop and see if you can feel it. Not mentally, physically. Try it again, Jim. Go ahead. Stop twitting.
The only way I would ever be on a red carpet is if someone shot me on a white carpet.
Raise your hand if you felt it physically. All right, one fat guy and one in shape guy.
It hurts.
Just kidding.
That
not good.
You were really that's trying
that
so hard. And then it the last one we have on here just ends in pure desperation.
Right.
This is pure desperation. After tweeting Jon Favreau three times.
Wait a minute. No, wait. Wasn't there another one?
There probably was.
Yeah, we just got the better ones.
Okay,
yeah.
Good.
What was the picture in this last one, Bob? You remember?
I don't know. Okay. Red, I'll tell you when you
carpet
tell me.
Or something.
All right.
Oh, no, yeah. Who's him in a red carpet?
Again.
For the premiere of the movie.
Okay. Yeah, it's the same. I think.
I don't know. Like tell me the thing.
But it's to Jon Favreau again, and it's
my
just,
buddy John. Don't say yes, just John. Yes.
Did he ever write you back?
My buddy John.
Did he write me back?
Ever, yeah.
No.
If he did, he never would have written this last one.
If he wrote me back, I'd have him on the phone right now.
Oh, no. Would you?
No, but I just tried to say that.
This is the desperate one. It just says, do you read these?
Wait. Did you feel? Who felt that physically?
I felt
that physically.
I think everyone needs to raise
that.
That
one there. Hurt. Yeah. And I love how these everybody here does the same thing to you and Norton and him, and you guys are reacting like, yeah, fucking loser. Yeah, you do the same thing, you jackasses. And you guys, you're giving me shit for being a fan of somebody when all these people are your fans and do the same thing to you. So you're saying they're losers.
I do tweet the pictures.
You're saying they're losers for being your fans.
Yes, we are.
I do tweet. I Twitter the pictures.
And we write back to
our fans. And I write back and I say, yeah, I do answer these.
We try to answer as many as possible.
Can you be my friend then?
I think I am.
No, you fucking deleted me. Remember the day?
Yeah, the day where you told everyone
it was mass delete. Yeah. Everybody deleted you.
Oh, and I was snapping on these fucking everyone faggots on my Twitter for a couple days. I really wanted to fly out and fight some of these faggots.
Why? What happened?
Because it was a mass. I think I had like fucking. I don't know what it was.
It was a mass exodus from your Twitter. You were doing site. Good.
Some of them stayed, which I'm appreciative. But some of them like later, and they wouldn't even put like. They just delete, which I don't give a fuck. I thought it was hilarious. They all fucking took a nice hike.
Hey, we got a mystery guest here.
Oh.
We're going to have him talk from...
Anthony. Jon Favreau.
Anthony, can I be back?
Yeah, he's working
yes,
on that.
Absolutely.
You going to put me back in?
Yeah, you're back right
what
now.
What about you, Jimmy? I miss yours.
Well, why don't you follow me?
No, I was. You deleted me.
Oh, I didn't mean to.
No, you did. I said it on the radio.
For real, I didn't mean to. Like, yeah. I didn't know you couldn't follow my wit.
Everyone's going to start following you again, Bobby. Don't worry about it. It's time for the mystery guest.
I want to find Jon Favreau.
Are we ready?
It's Jon Favreau.
Are we ready for the mystery guest?
Yeah, I think so.
Is he going to just talk from somewhere? Try to figure out, Anthony, who this person is. Okay? Whenever you're ready, mystery guest.
I can't believe it's the last day of the studio.
Oh, no!
Oh, Jesus. Oh my God! Hard to figure out.
I think we need a little more. Mystery guest.
That's wow.
I don't work at CBS anymore.
Wow, that could be one of 10,000 mystery guests,
including us.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe you'll find another job.
The mystery guest.
I think we do his character better than he does now. Tim is here. Where's Tim?
Yes.
This is Tim from the old joint.
Tim.
No one ever saw him on the radio, but there he
is. Wow.
You got shown the boot right after us?
Oh, yeah.
Like the next day?
I was told not to come in tomorrow, and then tomorrow I got the call saying, not good news.
Really?
Yeah. Why are you still wearing this shirt?
Yeah, what's wrong with you?
I have... That's all I own.
All you own. Yeah. How long were you there?
22 years.
Jesus. Holy shit.
And we're pissed after getting let go after three.
22 years.
Wow. Yeah.
And what did they give you?
It was amicable.
Yeah. Oh, wow. That sucks.
Well, now it wasn't at first. I haven't signed the paper yet.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you better keep your mouth
shut.
Sorry
to hear that.
Yeah, that sucks. Sam wants to add something to this?
Years.
Yes, we have a very special prize for Tim Reed.
Oh, ooh, really? Oh.
For showing up to the studio, Tim Reed is going to receive E-Rock Turn It Around, the old free FM sign.
Wow.
Yeah. I like it.
We stole that?
We found it in the garbage.
For real?
In the garbage.
They did an about Schmidt?
E-Rock found it on the sidewalk with the garbage, so he brought it back to us to give to our fans.
Oh, that'll go right up on eBay to feed my kids.
Yeah.
Oh, oh boy.
Oh, oh wow.
All right, there goes. Well, it's a made out of it. Good to see you, buddy.
Yeah, wow. Come on, make
also,
some room.
Kent, the movie guy, has been standing there for literally a half hour getting tired.
Yeah. I didn't know you were Kent.
Yeah, that's me.
That's Kent, the movie guy, who calls the show from time to time and talks movies.
Hi.
And you came from you came from California just to see us today?
Yeah, just to see you guys today.
Wow.
L.A.?
San Francisco.
San Francisco?
Oh. Okay. Mm. Yeah, yeah. And yeah. I brought you guys some Blu-rays.
Ooh.
So,
We like Blu-rays.
Yeah.
So do I.
What do you got, Sam?
Look, you're each getting a copy of A Clockwork Orange and The Matrix.
Oh! Wow.
Oh, thank you. I have Clockwork, though.
Do you have it on Blu-ray?
Yeah, I do.
Oh.
Jesus.
Jimmy just lobbed it right back at him.
Thank you, Kent, very much.
Yeah, this is great. Actually, yes.
Yes. Anything else there,
Kent? Such a dickhead, man.
I was told that I should plug the fact that CNN interviewed me yesterday.
Really?
About the new Wolverine movie getting bootlegged.
Okay.
Yes. I'm supposed to say, eat that, Big Kev. So.
Oh, damn. Shit. Oh, no, you didn't.
CNN gotcha.
Because he'll say, okay.
Did Big Kev get an interview by anybody yesterday?
No.
Sam, no one?
New York won? No? Wow, yeah, what about that whole thing? Wolverine movie got out? What happened?
On April Fool's Day, a version of the movie came out that isn't finished.
Yeah.
And within a couple of hours, about 100,000 copies were downloaded.
Really?
And Fox is really upset because it doesn't come out till the first of next month.
Yeah.
And that means they're going to lose tens of millions of dollars.
But if it's not finished...
Like, doesn't matter.
Really?
Yeah. It's the version of the film isn't finished in that they did reshoots since that version came out. And it's bad enough that some people really hate it. I personally... Wow.
Is it terrible?
They should just turn it into a musical now.
Yeah.
With only a month left, they just completely reshoot it as a musical.
Yeah.
Without the special effects and temp score, it's pretty hard to watch. You get pulled out of the movie a lot.
I saw the trailer and I was like,
The thing is, all the X-Men movies have been about Wolverine.
Yeah.
So this one's just kind of like all those, but without the supporting cast.
And his fucking blades don't look as good.
They look really bad.
They look fucking cartoony CGI.
They look very fake, and his hand will move, and they'll stay.
Oh, great.
That's
great.
The digital effects
will they fix
are pretty
that?
Bad.
You think in post?
Yeah, maybe they were gonna still fix that up.
Yeah, maybe that's just
that is post.
Well, the version in the trailer is that bad?
Okay.
No, the version in the
trailer.
Yeah,
that's what I was
seeing
in the trailer. I was like, they did the first one years ago,
and it
looks
better.
Fucking 20 times better.
Yeah,
and that was CGI.
Well, they did a lot of prosthetic hand too.
Did they? I didn't know.
Yeah,
but
first
angrily.
Shot, the close up in the bar in the first movie was a prosthetic hand, and they should have stuck with that. But 20th Century Fox likes to cut corners a lot.
Yeah.
They did that a lot with this movie.
Whoa!
Cut corners. You don't care.
No, Fox already hates me because I wrote a review of the version that isn't finished.
Oh,
and then
shit.
CNN put it on. 8th
Century Croc. What's that?
What?
I didn't say. Fox is nothing but 20th Century Croc for cutting corners. You took away jobs from a lot of hard-working men and women.
I'm leaving.
But
that doesn't make any sense.
I think the Bobo Springsteen bit is officially over.
That was officially it.
Yeah.
That's the jumping of the shark.
He's jumping up and running to the mic with his finger up like, guys, Gem coming.
Yeah.
Yep. He is a fucking scary.
Yeah.
Dude.
What about let's see this trailers I liked Star Trek movie.
Star Trek
looks
really really good. It's weird in that it's a reboot, a sequel, and a prequel, all at the same time.
My God, man.
And
is it good?
From what I've heard, they showed 10 minutes at Show West this past week, and the reactions are really really good.
I like theme of forget what you've known. Like, throw away all the movies that came out with this title.
Christian Bale in Star Trek. Bale in Terminator.
Terminator.
Christian
Bale that,
yeah. in Batman. Christian Bale is in every movie that we want you to forget he's the old movies.
He's in another
Christian
film.
Christian Bale
in
Look Who's Talking.
Yeah.
Christian Bale's in Terminator.
Shut your
and,
fucking mouth.
Yes. Public Enemies.
That was another. I saw the Terminator trailer. Looked very good.
It's good. I've seen a rough cut of that too.
Awesome.
And it was really good.
What's going to be bigger, Terminator or Star Trek?
Ooh,
Terminator's
good question.
Rated R. So it's harder for
language.
Rated R film for yes. a lot of violence.
So Star Trek is he's not going to be fucking banging aliens in this one?
No,
I saw some kind of love scene going on.
No, yeah, he
if that's
a
young
green
Kirk,
alien.
He's fucking.
He does.
Kirk bangs a green alien in a leopard print.
Does
bikini.
Her face open up yeah. like a pussy, like the like alien movie?
I wish, but no such luck.
So
no.
It's just a chick, a regular
it's
just
a chick.
Green.
It's
green.
The joke of
the green
Kirk's
chick.
Always banging
the green chick.
Yeah,
and he never really did in the.
In the series, so now he bangs a green chick,
and there's nobody in it from the original movie.
Actually, like, Leonard Nimoy is playing old Spock, and that's where it kind of gets weird.
Wait, does he old Spock? Why? What do they do?
He comes. The plot is that
don't fuck it up for me.
I'm not. The plot is after the last film, Nemesis.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Romulus, or the planet for where all the Romulans live, gets destroyed.
Right.
And as a result, a guy wants revenge, so he goes back in time. To wipe out the Federation
DeLorean?
Before it starts. Marty? Huge DeLorean.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
He goes back to wipe out the Federation.
Before they can not save his planet. It
yeah,
really
yeah.
doesn't make a whole lot of sense.
I guess
but,
he's a little bitter.
Yeah.
That there's
yeah.
still the Federation and
so,
no Romulus.
And what happens?
Leonard Nimoy comes and follows him, and that's where the movie picks up.
And the
up.
Ship crashes because Mr. Sulu is shoving things into his asshole.
Oh my!
So which one's gonna be? You think Terminator is gonna be better? Why don't you ask John Favreau?
Terminator's gonna be better.
you dick!
I'd love to. Oh, if he just answered me once, it would have just felt. But better. I like the casual things like a friend would do. You gonna yeah. post a picture on or what?
Come
you know?
On!
Hey, come on, Suds and Buds.
Oh, he's probably looking.
Suds and Buds.
Yeah, beer and friends.
His assistant is going through there, just going like, "Who's this? Yeah, right.
Block
is this idiot?
Fucking pile of douche."
What up? Well, Star Trek does have that huge following.
It's got a huge following, and it's got a huge budget. They put another $50 million into it.
Hasn't been a Star Trek movie out in quite a while.
Do you think it was really
so
his assistant?
I think,
no. Yes. Just him ignoring you.
His assistant screens the fucking
I was kidding.
Messages.
I get it.
All right. And,
sorry.
Look, don't try to make me look foolish, friend of the fucking friendless.
Friend of the friendless.
Now I feel awkward.
I'm going to find John Favreau to become his friend.
No, I think that Star Trek will probably make more money.
It'll be good. Yeah. It'll be good. Actually, one movie I'm really looking forward to is Sacha Baron Cohen's.
Yes.
Bruno, I saw the fucking trailer for that.
You saw the trailer.
You like it?
No.
People are saying the trailer was hilarious.
I thought it was pretty funny, walking around nude in a see-through suit.
No, I like him
Velcro
a lot,
suit,
but it's like the whole, anything with, I didn't like the movie that much because it was set up. Like, I love the show, it was brilliant, mm-hmm. but I didn't like the movie was.
Borat, you didn't like
it
as much?
It was good, but it was like, I didn't like the fact that it was done as a movie. Like, I just like I'd rather have like an average fucking scene that's just real people shot
right.
than the funnier scenes in the movie. Like, I didn't care about the wrestling scene. And the Bruno thing, it seems a bit staged to mm-hmm. me.
You know what trailer I saw that I did not even get a chuckle at?
Year One?
The movie that Jimmy loved, the comedy.
But the trailer's probably awful. What's the trailer? I didn't see the trailer.
What was it?
For
with Ray Liotta
or something in report.
Are you talking about
report?
Ghosts of Girlfriends Past?
Oh my god. Oh.
Are you a ninja?
Me and Danny were watching trailers. We were watching douche chill. We were trying
about?
To find the most douche chill trailer
yeah.
where it's like they found love. In a place that they never expect
you. Yeah, you always know when a movie's gonna suck when the title cards, when one word of the title card is a different color.
Yeah.
And then it slowly fades in and fades out.
Love.
Matthew McConaughey, I do
yeah,
believe.
Yeah, Matthew McConaughey
the
and another piece
bomb.
Of shit.
Another bomb for him. Yeah.
Piece of shit.
That guy's good, though, man. He's fucking charismatic. He's got a magnetic personality. What was that one he did with Sandra Bullock or whatever?
Ugh.
What was the love story he did recently? It was really good.
That's like 100 movies.
Like Fool's Gold.
Oh, no, that was
Kate
Hudson.
Oh, Kate Hudson. That's good stuff.
Good stuff. That was so bad.
Yeah.
What's the big movie this summer there, Kent?
What's
the one everyone's
going
to be talking about?
Star Trek's up there.
And Terminator.
Damn. Terminator's way up there. I think a lot of people are going to really enjoy Terminator.
We got another Will Smith movie to watch.
Really? Where he's bringing his whole family in?
The one that's probably going to making the most money, even though people are going to trash it, is going to be Transformers 2. It's probably going to make a ton of money.
That looks good, though.
Yeah, I think it looks fantastic. And the way you're going to have to see it, if you really want to experience it, is in IMAX.
Right.
Same way they shot The Dark Knight. It's going to be huge. There's a scene in the trailer. Optimus Prime jumps on a robot that's twice his size. And it turns out that robot's actually only 1/5 of his actual size. So it's going to be
huge.
300 stories or 300 feet tall.
Yeah.
How do you fight that?
Ooh, with magic.
Huh?
Don't know. I haven't seen the movie.
Jimmy Fallon's going to tell us on his show.
Yeah. Jimmy, thanks for clearing that up, dude. Jimbo, it's me, Bobby.
I'm not fighting. I deserve every fucking second of this. I really am just a fucking lonely douchebag.
Why don't we let Kent go? Well,
Kent, they're telling us you got to go.
Thanks for the flight.
Who's they? Is that nobody?
That's the movie guy. Thank you for the DVDs.
Yeah. Do you got you got the mic?
What happened, Jill?
No, because does anybody I have a question. I want to know if anybody has any questions about foreign countries you'd like to ask.
Oh,
that's
a real question.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. See who has the first.
Anybody aware of other countries?
Oh, wow. Yeah.
That there are other countries.
Yeah. Yeah. Ask the guy from Once Were Warriors right there.
Jesus.
Very good.
Do you have any questions about a foreign country?
Not really.
Well, why don't you make one up then?
Yeah. Yeah, well, how about the one you're from?
Transformers.
Where are you from?
From Queens.
No, originally, your face. Like exactly.
Your
grandparents. Where did they fuck?
Me, Puerto Rican.
Oh, you're Puerto Rican?
Yeah.
Get the fuck. Really? Yeah. You look Samoan or something. Yeah.
Well, I get that a lot.
Yeah. Yeah. What, Sonny? You're kind of talking into thin air.
Yeah. Do you think the fucking Koreans are going to blow up the Chinese?
Oh.
I don't know. Jonathan, you want to answer that?
That's a tough one. The Koreans are going to blow up the North Koreans?
I guess so. Whoever the ones that are fucking developing all these fucking
I think Japan's
weapons.
A little more nervous about North Korea than China.
Yeah.
China can roll over North Korea, and they've been allies forever.
But the problem is North Korea's military is... They've put all their money into the military, but what's happened is that it's kind of a facade. Like, you know, when they have those big
false
raids?
Front.
Yeah, exactly. So I think the Chinese would win, to be honest. They have a lot more money, and that's the thing. People eat bark there for food, you know, from trees.
You ever see the satellite pictures of when the lights are on at night? And in North Korea, they're out.
It's
like this big black blotch because they can't keep their lights on.
Why?
Because they're fucking poor. They've made such enemies with the rest of the world that... except, like, China. Even China doesn't have a problem with North Korea. They were the ones storming in trying to keep us out of there.
The
Japanese
really...
are afraid. And they are apparently supposedly developed a missile that can put Hawaii in range and nuclear missile warheads.
Of course, the Indians, you know, have lots of missles, too.
Yes.
They're in Pakistan. But not as developed.
If those two want to blow each other up, who cares, right?
Exactly.
Who gives a flying fuck?
Turn it into a parking lot, right? You know what I'm saying?
We should introduce our friend here, Jimmy.
Well, that's my manager, Jonathan, who's got creepy knowledge of everywhere.
He's the one
and fantastic hair.
Postcard, Jim. Wait.
He's the one that's got Fidel Castro's autograph and all that.
Do we have headphones for him at least so he could listen?
I didn't fill him out yet.
What is this?
It's a postcard from Cambodia.
He bought him for you.
Oh,
wow.
He's
waiting at your house.
Yeah, I went there a week ago.
Oh, what's on the postcard?
It looks like the last kid that Dahmer killed.
Oh, wow. Young boys on the picture.
Location.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
Oh, wow.
Jonathan, where was the scariest place you've been? Jimmy brings back
besides
the stories.
Besides
the
studio right now.
Yeah, right? Scariest place. And why?
Jersey. Newark.
I would have to say... Well, let's see. I was in northern Laos, which, probably Myanmar. No, let me think for a second. Mm. You know where? In West Africa. I was in Nigeria.
Boy.
That's really scary.
Oh, boy.
That's really terrifying.
Well, do you get email when you're in Nigeria, do you get emails from Americans that say that you're going to get some money?
Prince Hakim has a fortune from his great-grandfather.
Yeah. I like their new scam where they have a bunch of... bills, they're the size of dollars, and they're completely
doused in ink, so you can't see them. And that's to get them out of the country. Because if you saw they were the money. But you have to buy the chemical to wash the black off of the money. And then you'll have all this money. And people actually pay them.
Mm. Yeah.
And then they, you know, mix the chemical in. Nothing happens, by the way. Jon Favreau told me that in a tweet.
Are you friends with him?
Yeah, of course.
Don't tease me.
He's a wonderful man.
Why was Nigeria so scary to you?
Because
I know it's a scary place in general.
There'd be no law there.
It's pretty scary. You have to have some kind of security apparatus with you, because if you don't, they light your car on fire. Yeah, that sucks. It's really lawless there. It's completely corrupt. Indonesia also. Jakarta is pretty scary.
You're like Elaine's boss on Seinfeld. You're like that guy, just kind of Peterman. Yeah, thank you. Just wandering around. Travis thought he was in a trivia contest.
He's like,
he bounced. He hit that button in my ear in a second. Man, I got the answer, Peterman.
I got a question to ask. If we have David go into Bin Laden's cave and room with Bin Laden.
Who's Bin Laden?
Laden.
Is he Jewish now?
If we room him with Osama,
then he's hiding.
Do you think he could annoy Osama enough that Osama will turn himself in?
Sometimes when you give somebody too much mic time, things just fall apart.
Who's David?
All of a sudden he's on the couch on the Mike Douglas show.
Oh my God.
Who's David?
Sorry.
David. Fuck's sake, man, you're amateur.
This is David.
Oh, sorry.
Uh-huh.
There's David.
Uh-huh, you bumped into something.
Just looking at David, without any knowledge of his background or anything, can you tell me if you've been to a country that perhaps his ancestors... Is he the poster boy for a bus bomb? Oh my God, look at him. He just
David.
David. What's the matter, David?
Nothing's wrong.
Yeah?
No.
You went to Israel, right?
Yes, I did.
You had to, right?
No, I didn't have
what
to.
What was it called? It was like a journey, right? There's something. Isn't there a Jewish name to like going
Free?
To Israel?
No, I didn't have to go there, no.
No, but isn't there like a ritualistic thing that American Jews go back to the homeland and it's called going on a...
No.
Oh my God.
Fuck me. What do I know? I thought it was some kind of thing that, like, when you did it, you...
Kibbutz or something.
Not a kibbutz.
No.
That's a kibbutz. Farm.
Yes.
Kibbutz, yeah.
Kibbutz.
All right, sorry, David.
There you go, John. So that's David.
Did you sit on the C4?
Oh,
it's endless.
I said, did you sit on the C4?
Heard you. We heard you. How about we take a little
break? I don't know what a C4 is.
What's that?
C4, the explosive, I believe he's talking about.
Oh, did I sit on an explosive bomb?
As opposed to an unexplosive bomb, right. Which is everything that's coming out of Bobo's mouth.
Yeah. Bob, did you have a question?
I gotta plug the ACM wallets.
Oh, will you shut up?
Endless.
This kid.
Thanks for the ACM wallet. I gotta plug ACM wallets.
We got it. ACM wallets. Buy them.
He has gotten a little too much confidence.
He sure has.
Oh, we're going to have to really start beating
the
shit out of
him.
It's
completely unwarranted.
David invited 5 people up. We're going to find out who those 5 people after the break.
And why.
And then get another story from Jonathan from the scary places.
Yeah.
Sure.
I like your plane stories where you fly with animals and stuff.
Maybe
we'll get into that after the break.
Yeah. Like Indiana Jones airplane trip.
As a rule, John won't travel anywhere where they have foreskin. Or I meant to say they don't have foreskin, but I said the opposite.
Oh, right.
So therefore it wasn't funny. Not that it would have been a home run the other way, but it wouldn't have been the foul tip off my fucking shin bone.
Speaking of foul
tip. That it turned into. Hey, Bobo, you want to redo that?
Drew Boogie, everyone.
Oh, no! It's Drew Boogie! Boogie!
come to Las Vegas and talk to a man like Mo Green like that.
Nice. Drew Boogie, everyone. Opie and Anthony. Jim Norton. RobertKellyLive.com. And Otto is playing the Primetime Comedy Club in
Sayreville.
Not from Jersey. Sayreville. Tonight and tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
Very, very good. And we got Bob Saget. He's stopping by within, like, minutes. And we still have some stuff to give away. No, we got to give away Bob Kelly's knee brace that we all signed.
No, someone bought that.
We got it right here, buddy.
Oh, you got it? Yeah, somebody bought that for like $1,200.
Oh, well.
For Katrina? Remember the Katrina thing you did?
What?
It's in my hand.
Oh, they never picked it up.
So what? You got the money.
No, it was a fake bid.
Smell it.
It was a fake bid.
I won't smell
it. So now we're just giving it away.
Sounds fine.
Is Bob Saget coming in? Is that the commotion? He's right there?
Yes. Okay.
Our old friend Bob Saget stopping
by. Can I put that on again?
We'll get to the... Bob Saget making a sitcom entrance, everyone.
Yes, he certainly is.
Bob. How are you, sir? Good.
How you doing? Bob Saget. Yeah.
Bob's like, what did I get myself into?
I know, right?
You shoot me in the gut.
What the hell is this? Our friend, our good friend, Bob Saget. How you doing, good?
Hey, what the hell is that?
This is our live audience portion of the program.
How are you, Bob? See you. How you guys doing?
Yeah.
Hi, guys. How are you
doing? Good. A little different than the America's Funniest Home Video.
He just shook Bobo's head.
Yeah. I know.
Bob's gonna do some crowd work.
Feces now.
Yeah. What did Bobo? Yeah. Bobo, what did you say? Hi, I'm Bobo. He expects there to be like a spark of recognition.
Yeah, hey, you're Bobo.
I'm the newest person on the show, Bobo.
Yeah. I'm the newest person on the show, Bobo.
Is he the last person on the show?
Yeah, he would be the last person on the show so far.
Where's he been before here? Because I touched him. I don't know what the hell's going on.
That's a very good question.
Yeah. Want some Purell?
Where were you?
My hands are clean.
All right, that's all I need to know.
You know Otto?
Otto from Otto and George, yes. This is our last day at this facility, so big crowd, obviously.
I like it here.
And then we're going to move over to the big building, the Sirius XM building.
Would you like that?
So we're going to be moving. Yeah. It'll be all right.
Are we going to do anything to this place before we leave?
We want to burn it.
Just burn the building down.
Maybe just like write something dirty on a dry erase board.
There's a guy who works here. I don't know what he does. He's a maintenance guy or something, but he looks like Mr. Whipple.
Yeah.
And I want to throw a bag of shit in his face on the way out. I fucking hate that guy more than I've ever hated anybody. That cock blocker with his fucking glasses and his little paunch, his little cum belly. I fucking hate that dude.
We should have Bob Kelly dry hump him like he did Sam earlier.
Oh, that's just, I'm in love with Sam.
You're not like that.
I'm in love with Sam. I can't resist that.
What does he do here, this Whipple guy?
He's cleans
just,
up.
I don't know. We don't
it's
know
like
what
a janitor
does.
Or some shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jimmy's very angry with him, though.
Real, no one
likes
him.
He hasn't cleaned your shit up, is what you're saying.
No.
He made a mess of it.
Throw it right in his fucking face. He hates us. He can't wait for us to go. That guy's happy that we're going.
By the way, Jim, did you do the piss under the stall trick to somebody?
I did not. It was done to me, actually. I don't want to say by who, but somebody was next door to me, tinkling, and down! All of a sudden, there was spray on the floor, and I'm like, somebody's peeing.
That's what I
do to Jon Favreau, dude! he's been twitting to Jon Favreau. That's why Aiden Favreau won't respond.
To no avail.
Yeah, to no avail.
He just... Are
you on Twitter?
Are you on Twitter there,
No, I'm not. No. That's a thing you put in a woman, right?
Yeah, here's...
No, that's fist.
It's got three rotating... That's what?
That's fist.
Fist. Sorry, I got confused. But if you can get more, you do fist and the Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
It's got three rotators. You can probably carve celery with it. Say something, Jim. I just got here. I'm a tired man.
He's just warming up. Yeah,
I just came from Good Morning America. It feels good to
piss.
Talk
You stepped
again.
In my piss?
Oh, why? They don't let you talk over there?
Well, you don't talk about, you know, fisting.
No. No.
Hey, this is a little different than Good Morning America. That always amazes us that you guys go from such a nice, wholesome place to this show immediately afterwards.
Yeah. I was on there, and they're like, hey, you want some milk and cookies? Like, yeah, let me put my balls in it. You can't,
you can't do that.
Nobody wants to drink that. They're ruined the choir boy for his whole career.
What?
It's very quiet after I talk. It's good.
I'm amazed that you still
gives me time to think.
I'm amazed that you're still doing fisting lines with another big hit show on your hands.
Well, I'm doing Ready that in a riotous fashion, like I'm at a U2 concert.
Yeah,
going crazy.
It's the celebratory fest.
Sure.
Not the raping.
I thought you would go back to being safe again.
Well, I'm relatively safe. You know, you were a fan of the last thing I did. I couldn't even believe it. And now this thing. I forgot the name of it, but
I was a fan at the time.
It was one versus 100. It's the odds.
Of course.
It's the odds of him getting laid ever. That's not true. You're gonna get laid by everybody in here.
That show's dead. You think, Bob?
Yeah.
That sucks.
And I can't. But That'd I can't do it because I got this sitcom that I actually. Love
Surviving Suburbia.
Yeah,
on ABC, right?
Yeah, it was written by Kevin Abbott, who wrote Roseanne and Reba and Grace Under Fire, and he's a guy who wrote 8 years ago. He wrote this thing. He couldn't get it sold, and it's about his wife and his kids and just how life is. How he just wants to be left alone. How he just wants to live in the suburbs and just be there. Yeah. Don't borrow your neighbor's house key. Don't do anything. Don't do your kid's school project. Just try to stay out of it. Drink as much as you can. It's what I'm playing.
What's the theme of it? Is it like a little darker than?
Yeah.
Because it seems like Bob told me about it the other night, and it seems like it's a little bit of a darker, which is great. Than like typically what you'd see on ABC, which is usually pretty.
And they're running it at 9:30 after Dancing with the Stars, it just has a little bit more of a, I guess you'd say, an edge to it, but it's just a little more me. It's a little more what I'm like. I hope.
Right.
Actually, I'm more of a bastard in it than I am in my life because I. You know, I talk dirty just because I'm probably a nice person, you know, so right. I compensate by talking about somebody's clam or something, you know, just to make me feel better, right?
Is this show going to cultivate another couple of billionaire twins?
No, thank goodness. Unless we do stem cell growth off of one of the kids, we can make an octocock out of them or something. We could take a scraping and put four little tips in the garden and see if we can make a menorah of boys. Four Jews laughing, and that's the rest of it. This guy just shit his pants right here.
Bobo,
you shit your pants.
Bobo, you're not upset, are you?
No, I'm not. Actually, I'm not Jewish.
Well, I can make you Jewish in 10 seconds. If you got a staple remover, I'll just do it quick.
You want to meet our Jew?
Yeah, we do have one.
And he's great at interviewing.
I believe that line was said on Hogan's Heroes.
David, you got a question for the great Bob Saget, who's been a friend of ours for a few years now.
No, he doesn't have to say anything.
What's the matter?
What's wrong? Nothing. You don't want to ask Bob Saget a question?
You said you wanted to.
How do you know Bob Saget?
Yeah, I remember.
Uh-oh, something went
What's
wrong?
What's wrong?
I'm trying to come up with a question.
Yeah. Were you bar mitzvahed?
Yes, I certainly was.
Did you watch Full House a lot?
I watch Full House all the time. I'm a big fan of it.
Really?
Yes. Are you a little nervous? David, are you
I'm
a little
concerned.
Nervous?
I'm concerned for your well-being.
Are you nervous?
Why is that?
Because it was a show mostly made, and not putting you down, man, because I'm a Jewish guy. I watched a lot of TV when I was young, right. You know. But it was mainly made for 14-year-old blonde girls, is what the show was originally made for.
Uh-oh.
That's why I watched it.
Yeah.
that's a different reason.
Something I have in common so I could talk to them
but you watched it
before the duct tape went over their mouth.
That's what I'm thinking. You watched it yesterday.
Yes, of course.
You had a neighbor lady strapped to your chair, and you're like, you're going to watch Full House. I was like, Clockwork Regards to you.
Yeah. I think David's nervous. Are you nervous, David?
Yes, he is.
No, I'm not nervous. I just didn't prepare any questions, that's all.
Yeah, but when Kevin Nealon was in here, you were yip-yip-yipping the whole time.
Yeah, I knew a lot of things to ask,
Well, he's been on a million great shows, this guy.
America's Funniest Home Videos, you ever watched that?
I remember that.
See, the audience looks just like it, doesn't it, Bob?
It's exactly the same. Yeah, I would like to hit you in the nuts and videotape it. You remember that? People got hit in the nuts on that show?
A lot.
I do remember that. A lot of crazy stunts. It still exists, that show.
It certainly does. I was
without Bob.
Sometimes I forget this stuff. Yeah, they actually, Tom Bergeron is going to be on sitting in the audience Monday on Dancing with the Stars with Cynthia Stevenson, who plays my wife in the sitcom. And Tom is going to make jokes because, you know, it was called America's Funniest Videos after I left, but it was America's Funniest Home Videos when I did it.
Yeah.
But then a lot of people became homeless. I think they got sensitive to it. So they took out they made it Funniest just Funniest Videos.
Right.
Now
right,
it's
right.
just AFH or AFVH. What am I spelling?
Just AV now.
HIV, I think it's called. Something like that.
They're not that funny, those videos.
No, those videos are
painful.
Horrible.
Yeah, but they're doing
eating
better.
Some broth and petting your poodle.
But there's a cocktail now, so you're able to help those videos.
Yeah. Apparently so.
Yeah, the slow music starts, somebody falls asleep on the floor in the middle of the court scene. All right, this is a fucking downer.
Oh, God. Goes in the bathroom, puts on makeup. It's horrible.
David, he's also the narrator from How I Met Your Mother.
That guy?
You.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're looking at you. I thought that was so cool.
I didn't know that. You're the narrator. Wow.
Yeah, I narrate that. It's a Josh Radner who looks...
Your humble narrator.
A very easy job, right,
He and
Bob?
I could date the same age girl. That's what's so disturbing. But I play him old.
Yeah.
It's a fun job. I get to go there and hit on the women verbally, and then I find out they're all pregnant, and I go home alone. But it's good.
Who do you play old? David?
Josh Radner is Ted. He's Ted.
Oh, okay.
Do you know who the mother is? Do you think you know who the mother is?
No. Mrs. Sheckler!
Yeah.
No, Ted.
No. Hey, Patty, did you...
The random woman in the basement?
Bob, do you know?
I kind of suspect. I think it's Neil Patrick Harris, but I'm not allowed to talk about it.
He's someone's
but my new show, I think you're going to like.
Surviving Suburbia.
I hate the segue because, you know, the joke I had accidentally did on press was I want a hit show, and by mistake, I'm looking for a shit hoe. And you don't want to say that.
No.
Because that's
not
what you want.
That's not good.
Right?
And they won't invite you back.
If you don't get a response here with that, there's nowhere else for it to go. That's going right to 1 millimeter.
Yeah, you can't take that anywhere else.
No, I can scrub the hard drive for that
one. Are they on Good Morning America and shows like that? Are they just like, so Bob Saget's return to television? Yeah. His return to the sitcom.
And it was it. That was it. Nice to have you here.
Yeah. They're telling us you have to go.
He never went away, though. He went from show to show to show, this guy.
I will not be ignored. I'm even getting ready for my mugshot. You know, I just keep the hair closed on the sides. Don't let it be sticking out like Christopher.
Yeah, watch that.
Marty, 81 gigawatts. You don't want to look like Christopher Lloyd. Christopher Back Lloyd. To the Future.
That show never comes up.
No.
They are obsessed with that fucking show.
Does that come up a lot?
Oh my God. Back to the Future knowledge on this show is unbelievable.
You know,
Bob.
There's so many time travel paradox that can be discussed.
The DeLorean.
Of course. Well, you know.
But in Suburbia, you don't have that kind of shit, you know?
Oh, look at how you tied that. You brought that right back around.
Surviving Suburbia.
I had my tubes tied on everything but Surviving Suburbia. I think you'll like it. I mean,
Patty's coming up to the mic to ask Bob Saget.
Okay.
Look how
Patty.
Nervous she
you remember
is.
Stalker Patty, Bob?
Hi, Patty. I do.
What'd you say, Patty?
I was waved up to the mic.
Well, you said you were a Saget fan and you wanted to ask questions. Go ahead.
I think she said she was raped up. Well, that would make her a Saget fan.
She's a 54-year-old virgin, somewhere around there.
Yeah, you've met me before.
I have. It's very nice to see you.
He might not remember. He meets a lot of people.
Yeah. I never forget a face.
Oh, really?
Or the top of a head.
Yeah,
wow.
I've enjoyed Full House from for years.
Right.
Yeah.
Me too. We have that in common. Ask me my favorite episode of Full House.
What is your favorite?
The last
episode?
One. Because then we moved on, and everybody's happy.
And you still got the checks.
David officially has a question.
No, I was saying I remember the last episode.
You do.
The last episode of Full House was the one where she fell off the horse and had amnesia.
No, that's Gone with the Wind.
Yeah. That's right.
A little more than amnesia.
No, that's the horse fucker. It's like the horse whisperer, but they didn't whisper loud enough.
Filmed on a farm up in Oregon.
No, it was in Seattle.
God damn it. Why do I keep thinking it's Oregon?
Because that's where you get fucked by horses. I jerked off a pony in Asbury Park once. My new laugh.
If that was the last last episode, right. That would leave you hanging. What happened after
well,
she
horses
got
always are hanging.
Oh, yeah, that was fine.
No, we didn't. Yeah, there was a double-parter episode that ran after it, but I really seriously can't remember it. I have blocked most of it.
She fell off the horse at her horse meet, and then she had amnesia. She didn't remember anybody else. She didn't remember you or Uncle Jesse.
What the hell woke you up is what I wanted to know.
Now he...
What, did you just have a pap smear or something? I never saw anything like it. You were quiet before. Yeah. I attacked him with a pap smear. That was that means I've been doing comedy too much.
Yeah, it's all
pap smear. Yeah.
David, officially a question. One last question.
What was that? What was that one TV show that you were on for like one season? It was on the old WB network.
Yes, Raising Dad.
Yes, yes.
With two people that became successful, Kat Dennings and Brie Larson.
Raising Dad. That's what they're going to call the Brady Bunch reunion.
This is the last day in this facility, and I came here for that. That's kind of cool.
Yeah, it is kind of cool.
It's weird, because I've been around a few poignant moments in this place.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to forget a few of them.
Well, yeah. Everyone came out, and we couldn't get... there was at least 60 people that couldn't get in. They were just waiting out in the rain.
Yeah, they were nice.
They couple just bastards.
Anyone else up. That wasn't our problem. I'm sorry to those people, but...
Not our decision.
Or, yeah, certainly not. Yeah.
And I'm running right out. I got things to do.
What are you going to do?
I don't know.
Go on vacation after today.
Not Wait. Talk to these motherfuckers.
Well, don't you usually... don't you usually
teasing,
go right
of
to the,
course.
You go to the top of a bell tower right away. You get
yeah, exactly. Right back
full,
to it.
Full ammo.
Yeah. I load up a clip and well, just
was,
start picking out innocent
victims.
Of
you. We did... Here I go back to the thing, but we did a pro-gun show, and I had like a Magnum. I ended up with a Magnum that this guy Jerry Burns gave me, and I was like...
Who gave you one of my rubbers, Bob?
Oh, Jimmy.
No, a gun that fires blanks. Oh, it was one of your
Thank God something pulled that bombing Magnum joke out. Wow.
Your Magnum had a reservoir tip.
My fucking Magnum joke. This is the sound it made.
That's it. So it had a DVD.
What did
in
that
it?
Sound make?
The same sound fucking Favreau made when he responded to you.
Ouch.
Cha-chan!
Oh, God. It hurts.
So did you shoot? Did you?
I shot the thing. We went to our firing range. My wife didn't like it that I was playing with a gun, but I thought it'd be good to get the kids disciplined.
Yeah. Boy, that'll get them
it's
in
like,
line.
It's like, make my bed, that kind of crap. You know? You do your sitcom. And it was, I like the thing. It's got more of an edge to it, I think. Or not, it does more like me, I think.
Yeah.
But we'll see. We'll let you be the judge of it. There's nothing I can do.
Yeah.
You do the best you can. ABC's like promoting the crap out of it. They're doing a nice job.
What, promoting
You're
what?
All over the place.
The thing, Surviving Suburbia.
Oh, yeah, that.
You remember his
Monday
show.
9:30 on ABC.
You're, has all the blood left your head to have to promote this?
No.
You're like, no, Bob, I'm really excited to promote your show.
What have you been doing since the last time we saw you? You did the virus show for us and everything?
I did. We
and
had
then
so
you
much
disappeared
fun.
On us.
I did. I started to go into, I went into a loft. I sat in a loft like Anne Frank, and I just wrote my diary. No, I did a little bit of stand-up, but mostly I went and got ready to do this show.
Yeah.
I worked on it for about half a year, and just, people don't really give a shit, but the thing is, it worked. It was really important for me to do some acting that I thought was good.
Yeah. Do you walk in there, though, and think like, I mean, obviously, you love the show, you love doing it, but do you walk in there and just go, oh my God, I'm doing this again.
Yeah, but not the same because I'm out of my mind while I'm doing it. I got like 55 pages to remember, and nothing I say is very family friendly-ish.
You're not sitting on the edge of the bed going, hey, it's okay.
No, there's no organ music, no morality play.
Yeah.
Sometimes moms die.
Those were
Uncle Joey will come in and take over because I'm not really your dad.
Those are some of the best moments on that show, man, on Full House, where you would sit on the edge of the bed and just kind of words of wisdom to the kids.
Yeah.
And I'd be watching this going, he is a degenerate.
Well, not
who is he?
I really believed it while I was saying it.
Did you?
When they said cut, that I pulled a balloon out of my ass. But
after a while, I love how the show just turned into like a sponsor thing. Like you went to Disney for a few days.
Yeah, it's a double
for the
parter.
Show, and it was just a huge commercial for Disney.
Yep. I'm hoping they do ads for like Imodium and stuff on the air so I can do something I can use.
Yeah, to that. Quaaludes, whatever. Right. You need. Heroin.
Condoms.
Magnums.
Roofies.
That was a good one, Hopi.
Good. See how that hurts?
I was stuck in a spiral I couldn't pull out.
Just yelling out random names.
Jeff Favreau! That's always a good way
to ask. Favreau was here
blame on you.
No, it's a whole thing we've been doing.
Bob
with
has been responding to John Favreau's Twitter.
I was on Twitter and I was talking to John Favreau like he was like my friend of mine.
Like
he was
friend.
Not responding.
He was hoping to make friends.
Was it him talking to you? Think
no, he was talking to everybody, just his fans in general. I became one of his fans, and then they actually got all my tweets to him. Like, hey, you ever gonna post a pic, buddy? And I just wanted to hug Bob. That's
right.
So we're
out of stuff to do. Basically, is what's happened.
Yeah.
We're on Twitter.
Yes.
I mean, remember Zelda? Weren't things easier then when you just sit there and cut trees with the Uggs? And
well, at least it started out with MySpace. I mean, you had Inbox, Outbox, all this stuff. Now it's just down to the actual, you know, update. What am I doing this second?
It's the
only
meat
one sentence.
It's the meat and potatoes of it all. Yeah, it's pretty much a text that goes out and
it's
anyone
everybody.
Can read.
140
text
characters.
Message for everyone.
So on the John Mayer cruise, that thing just—they keep texting and tweeting, and everybody knows everything that's going on, like in what toilet breaks in what cabin.
Yeah,
yeah, of course.
And you can take pictures and then pop them right up there, and
of the toilet
of the cock
duty.
Rings on your telephone if you're Jim Norton.
Yeah.
Oh, those are funny.
Do you think they can run promos of Surviving Suburbia on it?
Well, you want us to tweet it out right now?
Oh,
yeah. Can you tweet?
Yeah,
can you
we'll
tweet
that for you?
Surviving Suburbia.
Tweet the star. I'll put that. I'll take a picture.
Yeah, we have to take pictures of you though.
Oh, you
I'll
do.
I'll take a picture and then I'll put the star.
I would do it, but I have no more friends.
Well, I got you back again.
We're back. Okay.
Yeah, you're like back.
Well, then tell your friends.
My pal.
Give me a better shot than that.
Tell your friends.
Tell your friends.
Here, let me take these off.
All right, now give us something.
Give you something.
Yeah, here we go. One, two, three, go. Yeah, there we go. There you go.
I'm selling a car no one's ever going to buy.
There it is. And I'm going to
write. This show is something you'll like.
I'm going to write the star.
Anthony, I'm telling you, this is your kind of show.
I like.
Yeah, I think. I mean, the guy doesn't want to leave the house. He doesn't want his neighbor to come over. He steals a handicapped cart to get in line at the DMV.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
that's something
like
I would
that.
Do.
You got the wacky neighbor? Yeah.
I got Dan Cortese, who owns strip clubs and coin-operated laundromats, and a 17-year-old hot daughter that I can't hit on because I'm married.
But maybe. Do you sort of hit on her?
I kind of do. Let's not talk about it, but yes.
You kind of hint that you might be... All right.
I don't do anything physical to her.
Just kind of leave things on the front of your pants and go, oh, what's that?
Bob...
How'd that drippy thing get there?
Bob, it would be my honor if you told me what to write for the Bob Saget picture.
Before I too late. This. I'm already up.
I know, but honored. You don't got the quote from Bob Saget himself. That's the difference.
I am honored to be in the final day.
No, you can't make it too long. We only got about 100.
You only get a certain amount.
140
of, characters.
140 characters.
My taint misses you.
You go through that really quickly too, don't you?
Yeah.
You're like ting 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 ting. What the hell happened?
Hold on. Taint misses you.
I got it.
You can have as much as you want.
Taint is like
though.
Between Jersey and New York. It's the right area. It's right in the taint.
I'll tell you
later. Whatever. That was fun at the Cellar the other night.
Yeah. I was surprised to see there. Nobody told me you were going.
I didn't know either. They just point me places and I stand.
Is the New York Times doing an article on you?
Yeah, they're doing something where I'm out in the city. That'll be in next week after my obit.
That's cool.
A little hard to do.
They took a picture of my balls and sack, and that'll be the obit.
Mrs.
Otto.
Sorry, man.
You. Perfect.
Now, what happens now? What happens to this building? What happens in this studio?
I think they're trying to knock this building down, to be honest with you.
And they just had trouble because it's so well built.
It's a famous building, though. They can't knock down the Steinway building.
Yeah, it's a...
The Steinway piano?
Yeah,
they're downstairs.
You didn't notice the piano's downstairs?
No, when they knock this down, there's going to be a huge crescendo.
Oh, shit.
DC Alcoa.
Oh, there are some moans and groans going on.
Well, they can all kiss my balls.
That's line starts over there and start kissing.
David, you look kind of... you're just kind of waiting for something. What's happening?
Yeah, David's lost.
Yeah, David.
I'm not waiting for anything. I'm listening.
I'll be dead if I was once for my son, David.
I'm disappointed that you don't
that
have,
out.
You don't,
wow.
have the, you don't have the questions for
ready
Bob
for vacation.
I have another question.
Sure.
Another question.
Yeah. What's this organization that you're
benefiting. You're doing a benefit NAMBLA? At the end of the
he said benefiting, not
right? Or,
don't tell him about NAMBLA. Oh, I'm just going to take him.
Punch tap.
He's going to take your NAMBLA to work day.
We are stumbling.
I'm sorry, David.
It's all
right. Stumbling to the finish line.
It's one bomb after another. It's fucking amazing.
I can't even get the words out to bomb.
It's shock and awe.
I feel like we cut David off and he was going to say something. Yeah.
Oh, David, go ahead. Apologies.
Cut that off when he was born. Part of his bris.
Wow.
Come on, it's a Jew circumcision joke. It doesn't even work.
I think people are a little sad.
Yeah, that's what it is.
At the lack of wit coming through these microphones.
David, tough room,
Dave.
Holy shit.
Dave had a mood swing. Yes.
No, I was just going to ask Bob about the organization that he's doing a benefit gig for at the end of the month.
Yeah.
You can explain about it. Like, what's the cause? Something with eating food and dinner and stuff?
Yeah, they give you food. My sister passed away from a disease called scleroderma. So I'm involved in the Scleroderma Research Foundation.
Oh, this
so
will bring the room up.
And it's good food. And it'll be April 29th in San Francisco, and Dave Koz and Dana Carvey and Bill Bellamy, and we try to raise money for people that have the disease, and we do it here in New York, too.
What is it, scleroderma?
Scleroderma. Huh.
What happens?
Any more happy questions, David?
Jesus.
It means hardening of the skin. It's when your skin hardens. Some of you probably have not experienced.
That's what Lucian died of.
Is that true?
Really?
Yeah, around the comic strip, yeah.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Yeah, Lucian, yeah.
What's it called when it happens to your brain? Oh, wow.
David.
Is your hardening
well,
questions.
That's what I was trying to let people imagine themselves, thing. But they're not imagining.
I know how to pick us up out of this fucking
right.
bomb fest.
How?
We all saw When We Were Kings, right? After Don King came in, the Muhammad Ali documentary.
When We Were Kings.
George
no
Foreman.
One saw it.
When We Were Kings? Yeah. The guy who was in Zaire was Mobutu. What was his full name? Can you tell everybody his full name, please?
Joseph Désiré Mobutu Sese Seko Kuku Mbendu Wazabenga.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah. Hey, there you go. Yeah. Yeah.
My manager doesn't even know my name. Who's your manager, right. John Favreau?
Nice exchange, nice volley.
I felt like I just got slapped in the face with a glove.
That was a nice little volley. That
was
that
good.
Went back
I liked
and forth
it.
Before the ball hit the ground again.
In my face.
Nice.
That was a good one.
We've been serving into the net for the past fucking hour.
It's fucking awful.
It's a fault.
So that movie is the George Foreman grill in it?
It was actually what got him started down that road. He got such a bad beating that he went into a depression. Then he came out happy and he made the grill. What did Don King call him?
The Jolly Brown Giant.
Jolly Brown Giant.
That grill was supposed to go to Hulk Hogan, by the way.
Who's Hulk Hogan?
Hulk Hogan.
Hulk.
He said Al Roker, I believe.
All right.
Well, what do? You move in like 20 minutes?
No. Yeah, you want to help us with the couch?
Yeah.
Imagine we get him to get everybody to help.
I've been here so many times, I know what's on that couch.
Yeah.
And I ain't touching that couch.
No. It's not like there's any good jokes anyone has to lift and take out of here.
No heavy lifting there. Yeah.
No.
We were giving away a bunch of stuff from our office.
Yeah, we've been doing that all week.
We've been doing that all week.
You got staples? Did you get all that stuff?
Oh, everything. Yeah, from the utter shit to kind of shitty. And we gave away a pillow the other day that was in that office for a good 2 years or so. And we decided to turn out the lights and put a black light on it and see what it looks like. It was like a Peter Max painting.
It was
jizz stained, drool. And that was the pillow that E-Rock used to nap on.
Yeah.
But you could tell it was just shoved under people's asses while you had to pull out.
Well, let me ask you a question. Is it possible for me to get that?
No.
We gave that away.
Take that with me.
Yeah.
Well, girl was like licking it like an ice cream cone on the way out when she won it.
Jesus.
Sam could tell you what we have left there.
We
Bob.
Have four fabulous office prizes remaining.
Only
That's
four?
That's it.
What, everything else we gave away?
Everything else is gone.
Where's the animal crackers, Samuel?
The animal crackers have all been distributed.
Okay.
None left. None left, Jimmy. Sorry.
And juice boxes.
What's this? That doesn't look like a good gift.
This is a great gift. It's an autographed T-shirt by Hulk Hogan.
It's a Hulkamania shirt.
I like that.
A Hulkamania T-shirt signed by the immortal Hulk Hogan.
Put it on and rip it off.
No, I would never rip
it. Spelled-
put it on and rip it off.
It's spelt wrong. Doesn't say Hulk. Ass.
We also have...
We're just...
It's,
oh wow! Look at this now. That's the grand prize.
Why don't you explain that to Bob Saget?
Prize.
Explain that to Bob Saget.
This can't give that away. This is the wiffle ball bet. As you can see,
don't
Mr.
touch it, Bob.
Saget.
Yeah.
There are different markings with women's names.
How far? And, I understand.
Yes.
A metric. Sometimes you want to see how your kid's growth is. This is
yeah.
This is their ingrowth.
It's just like that, right?
I do not want to know from it.
We had to retire that thing. Should, we almost,
two of the marks were moving on it.
Yeah.
A couple of those marks were not vaginal either.
Hey, Bob, come on, please help. Oh.
Not kidding.
Well, at least she's saving herself for her husband.
I'd have said no shit when you looked so disbelieving, but...
If you'll notice, there's a very...
Who's the grand prize winner there, Sam?
Well, if you notice on the wiffle ball bed as well...
I'm just going to go.
No, it's please... It's there's, not you.
There's a very deep marking about 8 inches to 12 inches down with the name Travis.
Oh, Travis.
So Travis remains the champion.
Yeah. Wow.
Do we have the glass box that the wiffle ball bat came in?
Yeah, where's the display case?
No, what happened to that?
That display case is gone. We have the bat.
All right. Yeah, but what happened to the display case?
We have the wiffle ball bat.
Smell the bat. Smell the bat.
Sam, you have the case?
No, we have the bat.
You have the case, though. You took it home?
Can I ask a question? Is it possible that there are... There are diseases released just from him lifting that thing up. I mean, that's my God.
The last time that was inserted in a woman was probably 2 years ago.
But trichinosis, how long
did really want? Did you really want me to not step on that, Jim? That line.
That's okay. It was an awful line. It deserved to be stepped
count
on.
Count your blessings when your lines get stepped on today. That's how I feel. Thank God no one heard that.
It's amazing. It's a dud fest.
It's just dud stops.
It's fucking the dud stops here. See?
It's
horrible.
Huh? Yes, sir. So it happened.
We have the official Bob Kelly I broke my knee man knee brace signed by Dane Cook, Bob Kelly, Opie Anthony.
You
just
stop right after Dane.
All right,
we get it.
Yeah.
There's some controversy though. Bobby thought that this went away.
No, this is it. I have it in my hand.
Yeah.
Somebody's here.
Somebody bought it for $12,000.
$30,000.
Well, then
$30,000.
Today we sell it for $10,000.
See.
I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
Yeah, we could tell.
Look at that little voice.
We could tell by the reaction you got that was a joke.
Yeah.
The poker chips. Opie's poker chips.
Wow, those are famous. Wow. Those are famous.
And I'll ask Opie to sign it since they're not signed.
He throws those.
Used to throw those
at various people that he was annoyed with.
Still one of the biggest laughs I've had since we've been back on the radio was that moment of those poker chips getting thrown. Well, just, that fucking lady. I hope whoever gives it, he signs it and then throws it at their face.
Does that girl even listen to the show anymore? She came by with gifts for all of us, and they were the worst gifts ever.
She had a couch, right?
Yeah, because we needed a couch. That's right. That was one of the first things we did when we christened the studio. We said we need a new lesbian...
The lesbo couch.
Yeah.
How long have you been in this studio? I remember when you came in.
4 years.
October of 2004.
I was here with the week you came in.
Yeah.
You were all excited about it.
Yeah. Because it was our great return.
They beat us down.
It was our great return to broadcasting after we were off for so long for the
4.5 years ago already?
Sex in the church thingy.
Shit.
What are they going to do in this thing? I mean, how bad can it be defiled today is the question.
Oh.
I think they're taking a lot of this stuff over to the new joints.
Yeah,
they're going to mind it. And then
there'll be cubicles in here, and some office will never know the debauchery that happened in here.
Somebody should shit in a corner.
Why
we've been doing this to the mics all day.
We can leave something in the drop ceiling.
This is just...
It's a beautiful place, and there's little kids on the monitors, which is little.
Yeah. I was just saying, it says, I slept with 100 men, who's my baby's father?
Wow.
That is
that's impressive.
A whore.
Oh, is that, that's the girl? Ooh. That's the little girl that did that?
Ooh. Give her a couple of months.
Well, so I'm going to see, next time I see you guys, it'll be in the other place.
Yes.
And that'll be cool.
That'll be good.
We'll do all right.
We'll sit and talk around. You're not going to have any more grief. You'll be happy.
No, we don't have any grief.
You don't
have
any clothes. No,
it's just change.
A little bit.
I'm trying to keep it positive.
A little bit of grief.
Endings are as important as openings.
Yeah.
Oh,
Bob
Saget
has 5 minutes. That means we all have 5 minutes.
Exactly.
When Bob goes, we all go.
Right. Sam, why don't we give out the Hulk Hogan signed T-shirt?
I hate to end the magic.
Yeah.
What a way to go out.
The magic, the incredible disappearing laughs.
No.
Look, I'm up here swinging, motherfucker.
Holy shit. Wow, I won't miss this building. You know what? I'm never going to be so fucking happy to see that fucking towering glass shithouse we're going into. You know?
All right, Sam.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Let's see. The Hulk Hogan T-shirt.
We'll see who wants it, Sam.
Who wants it? This young lady right here raised her hand.
Chick with the nice tits.
Congratulations.
She get them to show them. Show them.
Yeah, you know what? Why don't you...
Don't give it away. She's got huge cans. Rip them out.
Are we going to get a...
Yes! And they're fucking... Oh.
Yeah, they're pierced.
Wow. I would have never known they were pierced.
We just got a little...
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Finally.
I think she just threw out the last pair of tits in this facility.
Well, yeah. Maybe not.
Maybe not.
Maybe not. Fucking A. You just erased everything.
Let it be known, Pat Fumanaki threw out the last pair of tits at this like facility.
His was just as nice. See?
Feel like I'm watching the movie Seven and Sloth is turning me on.
I think that's it. That it ends with Pat throwing out his tits.
No, there's got to be something else. There's more tits in here.
Oh, looking around.
Somebody pointed out the there's some discussions that go on in between commercials. Someone's pointing out the girl in the red and her amazing breasts.
Can we just is that your husband right there with you?
Yes. If I show them, can he have the poker?
Yes. Wait a minute. Stop.
Yeah.
Stop.
We've been waiting for this.
Slow. Not quick. Whoa.
How about this? If you show him, he can have the poker chips. If I can suck him, I'll sign it.
And if I can suck him, I won't. Wait, slow.
All right, and maybe she changed her mind jiggle. And you'll fuck the whole thing
yeah,
up.
Yeah, show those tits.
Go.
Wow,
Wait, I didn't see. I'm blind in this eye. Wait, go.
Those are lovely.
Fucking Christ, I want to cheat on my
wife. Chips. Wow.
No is there bra. Any way you can my bring an old, like a really bra. Old, can you bring an old dude in here?
Uh-huh.
I just want to look at an old man's old sack.
Is that him right there?
Right, old man's
are you the
sack.
Husband? You're the husband?
Yeah. Show your
Bob bless you.
Hey, wait, can someone show their sack to Bob?
Yeah, Bob wants to see a sack.
Come on, one guy show you a
put
sack.
Put Saget at the end
of
the
sacrilegious.
Sacrilegious.
Yeah, come on.
No, I'm just fucking around. No, don't do this.
It's too late, Bob.
No, don't
come
do
on.
No, that was like a joke. Wait,
come on.
Saget wants Saget. Get to me, say.
Four Bob.
We all do.
You bring it near me, I'll put some fucking hot sauce on.
You gotta stand back, sir.
Stand back.
I don't want to taste your nutsack. I was kidding around.
Watch that camera there.
Just
Bob,
a sack.
This is for you.
Look at
there
this.
You go.
Pull it out like bubblegum.
Show them.
Thanks,
Jesus Christ.
And that's how you survive suburbia.
Surviving suburbia.
ABC.
Can I see your tits again, please? Can I see your tits again, please, ma'am?
Jesus. Wow. It's begging.
I know.
They're high-fiving
you're
each
begging.
Other with their balls
just trying to
sweat.
Get that fucking hubba-bubba out of my head.
Wow. That's how it's going to end? That's going to be the last image we have?
He just won an Opie and Anthony WNEW WOW window clip.
Holy shit. That's a collector's item.
That's rare, Bob.
A window clip.
Put it on his balls.
Wow.
There is those things are so rare.
There's literally 10 of those left.
A window cling from Roger. Remember the promotions got Roger. Wow.
Sam, go ahead. Give her out the rest of the stuff here.
The Bob Kelly knee brace.
See who wants it.
I'll take it. I'll just.
I think we'll go to our friend Janine for her fabulous attire that she's wearing today.
What is she wearing?
If you'd stand up and model your attire.
What does it say?
It's my Sam shirt.
Why don't
Fix. The fix is in.
What does it say?
It's a
says, what's the haps?
Fix.
It's Sam.
It's Primetime Sam Roberts.
Ew.
It says, what's the haps? And it's a shirt. Who made that?
I did.
What?
I did.
You made a what's the haps shirt?
Is that just one? Is that a one-off?
Yeah.
Thank
I
God.
I actually made one for Sam, but somebody took it at Jimmy's signing.
Oh, oh really?
Who? I have people want them.
Wow.
I have Sam underwear. There's cum and blood on them.
It's your trophy.
Thank you.
All right. Wow.
And finally, is this the last one, Sam?
This is it.
What about red?
Whoever you give it to has to lick that. Has to lick the end of it.
Kenny?
No, that's not a big deal.
I'll lick it.
What?
Give it to Sonny.
Pirelli,
thank you.
Pirelli's been around a long time. Give it to Sonny.
Ah! He is licking the ripple ball bat.
Oh, God.
Wait.
That's been up a bunch of badges and shit.
Oh, God.
Aren't you glad you came here today, Bob?
Fuck.
Boy,
that has been in some horrible place.
Good Morning America's not going to give you this type of entertainment.
No, that is true. You would not see a man.
Diane Sawyer, right?
She was there this morning. But
is she hot in person?
Yeah.
She's a girl. Yeah, I've known her a long time, actually. Yes.
I think she's still.
She's a very cool
she's
lady.
She's 60 something, too.
Yeah, I met her when I was 25. I was doing a show out here.
You ever?
No, I never. I scratched my wrist in front of her, but I didn't do anything else. That was a beautiful image. Every time I come here, I have something in my brain that takes like about 2 years.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to run because they're going to go send me to worship the show that I'm selling.
Surviving Suburbia. Bob Saget.
When's it? What's the day? What's the premiere date?
Starts Monday after Dancing with the Stars.
9:30 on ABC, right after Dancing with the Stars.
No commercial.
Awesome.
We go right into it.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah, cool. That's the way to do it.
I think you'll.
And you'll be in the audience on Monday.
Yeah, yeah, I'm going to dance with the audience, stars. Dancing with the Stars, and they're going to hazmat me out of there. Right. I love you guys, and I wish you all the success in the closing of this place. I'll see you at the other place.
Yeah, right. Definitely, man.
Bob Saget gets the big out. Bob
Thanks,
Saget.
Bob. There
he goes. There he goes.
Bob Saget.
Bob. 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 Yes. Bob.
There it is. He's pulling his sack out. It's wonderful.
He's thinking about pulling out his ball sack.
Okay.
Good
thought,
luck, man. Absolutely.
I thought they were yelling bomb, bomb. I figured I made another joke.
You did. You did.
It's just nothing.
Holy shit.
It really is just a cluster bombing.
Yeah. It's a festival of bombs. Shit, that was funny.
I think we're just about done.
There goes Bob
I think
Saget.
We're just about
let's,
done.
Yeah.
Let's,
it's going to take Bob. A lot to clean up this mess. Usher everybody out.
What else do we need to do? We got plugs to do. Jimmy's
yes.
going to be in Bananas.
Poughkeepsie. And next week, my Down and Dirty DVD comes out from HBO.
Very cool.
So purchase that. And tonight, only two shows. And I'm not there tomorrow.
Yeah. Otto. You have fun today, Otto?
Absolutely.
Just kind of watching it?
Yeah.
It's tough today. There's too many mics on. It's
too
crazy.
Much shit going
too
on.
Too many great jokes flying around.
Yeah. You don't want to step on these great lines. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Otto's going to be at the Primetime Comedy Club with George.
With George.
With George.
Right.
Tonight and tomorrow. Route 9 South in Sayreville, New Jersey.
Correct.
More info, laugh.com or ottoandgeorge.com.
Yeah.
All right. Hi, Bobby.
Drew What's Boogie? Up, Opie?
Any plugs?
Yes, the great Drew Boogie on MySpace. Buy my CD.
Nice.
Yes. Buy Drew's CD.
Have you sold any yet?
Yes, I've sold plenty.
How many?
The listeners are very...
How many?
I made a nice, pretty penny off of that, and iTunes, and Amazon. The listeners are very supportive.
A few hundred, a few thousand? What are we talking?
And iTunes. Is that the discrimination version of iTunes?
Yes.
Why do I try?
Sonny is...
I don't know. There's almost a valor in it now at this point.
it's like charging a machine gun nest or throwing yourself on a grenade.
I think
all right, you just jump right in whenever you feel like it at this point.
I had to. I'm sorry.
That's all right. No
oh
reason.
Oh, my God. I can't take this.
All right, there's a huge banner being opened up here.
It says, oh, wow.
Yeah, go ahead, Sonny. Explain the banner.
The story
to
about this, right, was when you guys got suspended off of XM Satellite Radio for that month. All right, the pests, mostly from whackbag.com, got together and they paid for this sign to travel around the XM compound and sit out in front of it for a whole week.
Oh, wow.
And this was one of the signs of four of them
that
were made.
Hurt us.
Hold on to it. You're going to need
that
it again.
Didn't hurt us. You know, and I just wanted to, I wanted to present this today because, you know,
glad there's not a date on it.
Over to a, another facility.
I had to say, we have,
and, you know,
we had nothing to do with this.
Yeah.
I'm going to be able to really enjoy the fullness of the show anymore in person. Just wanted to kind of give them a warning what the pests can really do.
Very good. Thank you.
I'm not giving him a response.
Let's go.
I'm just sitting here now and saying, screw it.
Yeah. I appreciate it.
Let's see how they feel.
I've given up.
Thank you, Sonny.
Well, his vacation couldn't come a day too soon. Holy
You guys are going on vacation?
Yeah.
A little
Get
something.
The fuck out of here
Just
for
a
while.
Week off.
Yes.
Take a little time.
Actually, a week and a day if you count today.
And I guess I want to thank everybody for stopping by today.
Wait. Oh, is this on?
I'm trying to get us out of here. So thanks to the crowd. We appreciate
big,
it.
Big crowd.
All over. And we'll see you at the next
one. What about my plug, you jackass?
RobertKellyLive.com.
Now, fuck that.
What do you
Where
got?
Are you working? I'm going to be in
Virginia?
Virginia. Fuck!
Virginia Beach.
Virginia Beach. Funny Bone, next week. Wednesday to fucking Sun. Wednesday to Saturday.
We actually have a lot of listeners down there, too.
Yeah, Virginia Beach.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then I'll go to RobertKellyLive.com for my dates. Thanks, Hope.
It was a good day. So, Drew, thank you. Drew's going to play us out. We'll see you guys in about a week, man.
Later.
Yeah.
All right.
Later. Rock,